first thing to know about the St. Louis Cardinals is that they have some fine players. Neil Lomax and Roy Green, for instance, burned Washington for this 83-yard touchdown earlier in the season. And O.J. Anderson continues to be a punishing, effective runner. The Cardinals beat Washington in October on this Neil O'Donohue field goal. But the second thing to know about the Cardinals is this. They don't have nearly the big game experience of the Redskins. None of the Cardinals has ever played in a game with so much at stake. Never have they found themselves in this kind of pressure cooker, in this kind of stadium, with this kind of crowd, singing this kind of song. Stadium in Washington, D.C., sold out for the 140th consecutive time, and this is it. This is for all the marbles. If Washington wins, the Redskins win the NFC East. They're the champions. The wild card game would be the Rams against either the Giants or the Cowboys. If St. Louis wins, the Cardinals are the NFC Eastern Division champions. The wild card match would be the Redskins against the Rams or the Cowboys. So, it is indeed for all the marbles, and no matter how long you do games, when you get to one like this, they just go something different. I'm Pat Summerall, along with John Madden. And John, it wasn't too long ago that Joe Gibbs and Jim Hennepin were assistant coaches together, so they know all about each other's coaching philosophies. We talked with Jim Hennepin and Gibbs, and first of all, let's get to the Cardinals and how will Hennepin approach things.
Well, you know, I think Jim Hannifin probably learned more from last year's Super Bowl where the Raiders beat the Redskins than he did from being with Joe Gibbs. I think that a lot of teams learned how to play the Redskins on that day. And the way to play the Redskins is to play them aggressively. And that's what Jim Hannifin says, not only on offense and defense, special teams, but that whole package there. And he says what you have to do on offense, you have to spread them out. We have to go deep. And I would think that they're going to try to get to Roy Green early. He said, on defense now, you have to go after him. He said, you just can't sit there in defense. You have to blitz him. The last time they played him, they won, and they blitzed him over 40 times in that game.
But, John, to a man, everybody you talk to, not just the Cardinals around the league, they say we have to contend with John Riggin, the great Washington running back. He spent 2 days in the hospital this week in traction, came out on Saturday morning, Friday night late, in fact. I talked to him just a minute ago, and he said, I can't believe how good I feel. I haven't felt this good in a long time.
Yeah, you know, I've never seen John Riggins as pumped up for a game as he is today. We just saw him come out in the field, and he was running up and down the sidelines. He was hitting with Clint Didier, and I don't know if that means anything, but already John Riggins could mean a big problem for the Cardinals, because as Joe Gibbs says, our whole offense evolves around John Riggins. He's the best first down football runner that there is. He's the best short yardage and goal line. He said we have to run him on first down, create those second and third and short, and that's when we're playing Redskin football, and that's what we have to do today.
They will get their chance first because the Redskins have won the toss. The weather conditions today somewhat different than what we expected. 45 degrees, humidity of 93%, winds out of the south at 5 miles an hour. The forecast has been changed now to rain, and it's falling lightly right now. It's more like a mist than it is a rain. Neil O'Donohue, Mike Nelms, and Otis Wansley will be deep. It's Nelms that they'd like to handle it. One of the best. And here we go for the championship. Nelms hurdles outside the 20, about the 23. Dave Ahrens. It was the Cardinal who knocked him down. The lineups. The Redskins offensive backs and receivers. Theismann, the quarterback. They'll start Riggins. Calvin Muhammad and Art Monk are wide. Clint Didier is also a starter. Don Warren is the other tight end starter. Joe Jacoby, Grimm, Donnelly, Huff, and Mark May. And Russ Grimm made a remarkable comeback injured player on the field. It is a Redskin. Unidentified as yet. We think it might be Keith Griffin, their backup running back. Let's see if we can figure it out. He's number 35.
I'll tell you, let's just take a look right here at Keith Griffin. He really, he's leading the ball carrier, and we'll see him. He's leading Nelms right there. Look at the shot that they take right there on that block, and that's where he got it. Hey, he's still down.
It was John Good who came down and busted that wedge, put the hit on Keith Griffin.
We may see quite a bit of John Good today. You know, he could be the second tight end for the Cardinals. Doug LaFleur is injured. Greg LaFleur is injured. And John Good may play a lot of tight end.
Nothing, nothing. We just had the opening kickoff for the finals.
A few months ago, something new burst on the American scene. The Toyota Camry. Experts were impressed.
Peppy performance with fuel economy. U.S. News and World Report.
And it's got room.
Technical tidbits and thoughtful touches. Car and Driver.
And it's got room.
A landmark vehicle. The Christian Science Monitor.
The 1985 Family Camry from Toyota. Boy, has it got room.
Oh, what a feeling. Toyota.
I built my first house when I was 10. It was just a treehouse, but it's still up there, and I'm still building the last. My partner and I, we have a waiting list longer than this beam because we don't cut corners, we charge a fair price. Pretty much the same reasons we drink Meisterbrau. Sure, we could pay more for beer, but this has a great full-bodied taste without a big price. Come on, guys, we've earned ourselves a cold one today. How's it going?
Meisterbrau, big taste, without the big price.
Took a while, but Keith Griffin seems to have shaken off the cobwebs and got up and walked off and now is jogging over on the sidelines. Very encouraging sign. First down for the Redskins. They start there from their own 24. Warren moves, Riggins goes right. And Riggins gets out across the 25. About the 26, Al Baker tripped him up. The Cardinal defense includes Baker, Ramsey Dardard, David Galloway at right tackle, and Curtis Greer at right end. E.J. Jr. in the middle, and Thomas Howard and Charlie Baker are the outside linebackers. The secondary, Lionel Washington and Wayne Smith, the cornerbacks, Lee Nelson and Benny Perrin, the safety men. Second down and eight. Riggins got two. To throw. Chased and down goes Theismann by Lee Nelson. A blitzing safety man. They told us they felt they had to do that.
That's what they said. There's no way that you can just sit in normal defense. He said you have to press. Watch 38. Lee Nelson, he's a strong safety. He's coming from the outside. They don't have a blocker for him. Theismann looks up and the first thing he sees is Lee Nelson right on him.
A loss of 11. It'll make it third and 19, and Joe Washington comes in place of John Riggins, who strolls to the sideline.
And that's what you have to get to play defense against these Redskins, is get Riggins strolling to the sidelines a lot.
Monk moves out wide to the left. Didier and Calvin Muhammad split wide to the right. Theismann gets it out of there for Muhammad. Almost picked off by the Cardinals. Benny Perrin just couldn't find the handle. Looked like there might have been some contact.
Well, that was one. It looks like they had Muhammad pretty well watched because they have, it's man-to-man coverage here. See, with the safety coming over, Lionel Washington is running with him. Could have been a bump. It looked like Muhammad slowed up there and Perrin got over in position for the interception.
Jeff Hayes back to punt for the Redskins. Stump Mitchell back deep for the Cardinals, standing at about his own 46-yard line. Hayes kicks him high, but not that long usually.
And Stump Mitchell's an exciting guy.
And dangerous. This one hangs up there, typical Hayes punt. Mitchell at his 44. Stump Mitchell into Redskin territory, but here come the yellow flags flying. Mark Murphy on the stop. 41-yard punt, 11-yard return, a 30-yard net. And the Cardinals take over in pretty good shape, but we'll see what the penalty is. Jerry Markbright is the referee. I didn't hear what he said.
I didn't either. That there was a flag in the play, but they didn't march off any penalty, so it could have been one of those deals where they throw the flag and it doesn't count.
Didn't mean to do it.
Sorry. No penalty. Good flag, no penalty.
Otis Anderson is the lone Cardinal setback. That's Roy Green, who's in motion. Handoff is to the left side to Anderson. Trying to get around the corner, doesn't get much. Neil Olkowitz knocked him out of bounds. Let's look at the rest of the Cardinal offense. Lomax, the quarterback. Anderson, the lone runner usually. Roy Green and Pat Tilley wide. Tight end John Good, who started in place of LaFleur. Marsh is the other tight end. Luis Sharp. Doug Dawson, the rookie, starting in place of Steve. Randy Clark at center. Joe Bostic and Tootie Robbins, the other two offensive linemen. Second down and 11 as Anderson lost one. Now they go with three wide receivers. Danny Pittman is the third. Lomax to Tilley. Got him. Vernon Dean, the Redskin defender, and Tilley goes out of bounds inside the Redskin 40. Let's look at the Washington defense. The line is man and manly, the ends. Butts and Darrell Grant inside. Mel Kaufman, Neil Olkowitz, and Rich Mallott, the linebackers. In the secondary, Green and Dean are the corners. And Kent Coffey and Curtis Jordan, the safety men. Third and two. Have a fine young offensive line. They'll miss Terry Steve, but Doug Dawson's a good player. Two tight end setup. Anderson will get the first down. Curtis Jordan took him out of bounds. He got away from Rich Mallott to get just enough for the first down.
You know, an interesting thing in this first drive here by the Cardinals is they've had two running plays. Both of them have been to Otis Anderson to the left side. And Jim Hanifin told us last night he wants to start that way because he has a rookie, Doug Dawson, as you mentioned, starting at left guard. And he said sometimes a guy like that, a young guy, you want to run right at him, right off the bat, and kind of get him in the game right now.
First down, Cardinals at the Redskin 34. The Cardinals have won three in a row and have played extremely well lately. Is to Anderson. Lomax to Tilley, incomplete. Rich Mallott out there on the coverage. Good pressure by the Redskins. Dexter Manley.
Excuse me, Pat, and they had good coverage deep too. What Lomax was trying to do is he was trying to go deep to his tight end Doug Marsh. Redskins had good coverage on Marsh, so Lomax had to come off to a secondary receiver.
Here's a guy, Neil Lomax, who's really matured. There is Jim Hanifin, who was talking about how much he had matured with us last night. He's got a new offensive coordinator, and they really sing Rod Dauhauer's praises, don't they?
I tell you, Rod is an excellent coach. I coached years ago. Darn near 20 years ago, I coached with Rod. He has experience.
Lomax going for Green. Bumped maybe in the end zone, and no flag is falling. Green, number 28, right step.
Well, that was Darrell Green right there with Roy Green on that play. And we knew that the Cardinals were going to come out and they were going to try and go to Roy Green deep early. I said, you have to do that. You have to stretch him out, get him playing the whole field. I'll tell you, Darrell Green was running stride for stride with Roy Green. Well, they may have had a little bump there with that left side.
Might have been a little nudge or two or something in there. Joe Gibbs over on the other sideline looking on. Lomax out of the shotgun. Danny Pittman split wide to the left. Redskins on a blitz by Monty Coleman. Take him down and take him out of field goal range. They'll have to punt.
Yesterday, the Redskins were saying that
with Neil Lomax, you can't let him get a lot of confidence. You have to come with the blitz. And we see Monty Coleman coming from the left side. The back was there to block him. The back faked the block on him and just let him go in and get Lomax. Never seen one of those deals before.
Carl Bertzong to punt for the Cardinals. Mike Nilms back deep for the Redskins. Bertzong gets a lot of foot in this one. Nilms lets it sail over his head. Bounces in the end zone. They'll bring it back to the 20. Good kick. Just a little too good. Punt, no return, but they'll bring it back to the 20, so they net only 23. Nothing, first quarter.
In 1982, Toyota introduced a standard bed truck for $59.98, and it was a winner. Now, 3 years later, Toyota introduces a new standard bed truck with a more efficient engine, with more horsepower, and a warranty that's twice as long as 1982. For $59.98. Who says you have to pay a high price for progress?
It's a Radio Shack Merry Christmas.
The TRS-80 Color Computer 2 is a great family gift. On sale only $99.95 with these instant loading program packs. It's a game arcade, a home manager, an educational center. And you can learn to program. It's expandable with a typewriter quality keyboard.
Now this is a family gift I can really afford.
The sale price TRS-80 Color Computer 2, $99.95, only at Radio Shack.
Off in the distance through the mist, of course, the nation's capital. Buffalo leads Cincinnati, a touchdown by Craig Bell, their outstanding rookie. Cincinnati needs a victory to keep their playoff hopes alive. Detroit 3-0 over Chicago. Bears, of course, have already won the NFC Central Championship. First down, Redskins, their own 20. Riggins left side. And the diesel gets about three. Behind Jacoby and Grimm. And, John, aren't you surprised that Grimm is back so quickly?
I'll tell you, you know, he had that eye, and Joe Gibbs said he was back there on Wednesday at practice. Watch Joe Jacoby take off there on Curtis Greer. Greer was saying last night, he said the tough thing is you have to line up against Joe Jacoby, and he weighs over 300 pounds, and he blocks you. Then you have to get off him and try and tackle Riggins, who weighs 240 pounds. Now, that's an all-day job.
4 yards. Second and six at the 24. Back to throw. Outside to Monk. Art Monk, of course, closing in on the all-time number of catches for a year. That's his first catch of the day. He needs seven to break the all-time record. Held by Charlie Hennigan, set back in 1964, 101. Lionel Taylor had 100. And Art Monk now has 96. Moving up the ladder.
Joe Gibbs said yesterday, we'd like to get Monk that record, but we're not going to go in the game trying to do that. We have to win this game.
Third and short, Wansley lined up to the left side, and Riggins comes in that direction. Got the first down. Kurt Alderman was the first Cardinal.
You know, I think that's typical Redskin football there. You know, every team we talk about, they say we have to hold Riggins to less than 4 yards on first down. Now they got 4 yards on first down. Then he throws a little one to Monk on second down. Now he comes up third and short, and they give the ball to Riggins to get a first down. I think there's really something to that 4 yards on first down.
They do it so well when he's healthy. Bubba Baker, who had a chance, a legitimate shot, had an interception and a touchdown.
Look, he's still talking about it. He's showing, look, I had it right there in the hands. It would have been a touchdown. Ah, got it. You know, that's the one thing about a left end being so important, that he's a big guy. You know, like Bubba Baker is 6'6". But when he's on that left side,
you can take away a big part of the passing to that side, because to throw to your right side, right-hand quarterback has to throw over around that guy.
Second and 10. Riggins still in the game. And a handoff is to Riggins. He bumps into the back of Jacoby, and Wayne Smith drags him down. Only a couple.
John Riggins was telling us about that. He said, you know, he said it's simple to play for this thing. He said, I can stay in the hospital all week. They only have four running plays. And he said, the big thing is just get in there behind Grimm and Jacoby. It's all you have to do.
If you weigh 240, it helps.
Only one time, he said, we ought to switch places. He said, the only thing we'd have to do is add a number four to that jersey, and you could play for me.
Third down and 9 from the 32. Heisman back to throw under pressure. Didier's got it. Wayne Smith drags him down at the Cardinal 22. Clint Didier, 44-yard gain.
And that was a great throw by Joe Theismann, because he really got hit by number 65, David Galloway, just as he throws the ball. Watch Galloway coming from his left. Look at the shot that Theismann takes as he throws the ball, and he puts it right on the spot to Clint Didier. But now it's tough to throw a football and find a guy open, but to throw a football like that when you're looking out your ear hole, that's darn near impossible.
He was saying to us, Theismann was yesterday at practice, that he was still sore from last week's meeting he took in Dallas.
I'll tell you, Joe Theismann is a tough guy.
Cardinal 23, first and 10 Redskins, fake to Riggins. Going for the corner to Monk. Touchdown! Throw by Theismann.
There was also a great corner move by Art Monk, and a great catch, catching the ball and staying inbounds.
No defense against a play like that. Mark Mosley for the extra point with Theismann holding. It's good. 7-0 the Redskins. Beg your pardon, it's not good.
I think he missed that to the left. That looked like a... looked like what the referee was saying there, like that little wiggle deal looked like a shank job.
Hail to the Redskins. They lead 6-0. Touchdown.
Art Monk is going to come up as the inside guy. You see him right here. Now he starts to break to the corner. Makes a good move right there. But watch his catch. Outstretched hands, both feet inbound. Now watch Joe Theismann throw it again. Right after he throw it, he gets whacked.
Back live. Here comes Stump Mitchell. Flags are down as Mitchell is hammered just outside the 20.
See, the first guy down there was Otis Wansley again. What a big play he had last week against the Dallas Cowboys. One of the best special team players in the game. He come flying down there and put a hit on Stump Mitchell.
They keep talking about, every time we talk with anybody from the Redskins, injured Cardinal down is Stump Mitchell.
On the receiving team, first down, timeout.
I don't know that Stump Mitchell saw that hit of Otis Wansley coming. This is a tough thing. Stump Mitchell has to take that ball right up in there. Watch 39. Otis Wansley puts his helmet right in there. I'll tell you, he really gave Stump Mitchell a shot. He's still down.
He also got hit by Anthony Jones at about the same time. Redskins 6-0.
Recently, two American travelers dined at the Paris home of the famous chef, Ann Willen. The hostess, who founded Paris's La Varenne cooking school, served a special Chablis that had won first prize in a prestigious competition. The guests were complimentary.
Bon.
And when asked where the award-winning Chablis might be purchased,
Ann, do you know where?
The chef replied,
why, I should think just about any way you like.
Chablis Blanc, from Ernest and Julio Gallo. All the best.
AT&T is in mushrooms.
Pheasant or champignon?
How can a mushroom supplier from high up in the Rockies sell this perishable delicacy to the country's finest restaurants as fast as possible? Simple.
All to tell you, I picked some of the best.
With AT&T long distance service,
terrific.
Our people can show any business the best way to do business. The people of AT&T Communications, we're thinking about your business in ways you never thought of.
The Redskins got the touchdown, but they missed the extra point. Boy, that's something that will inevitably come back and haunt you. He just pulled it.
Had plenty of height.
Stump Mitchell is the injured Cardinal who's being assisted off the field now. He really took a wallop from Wansley and from Jones late.
Yeah, it looked like he did see Wansley, but didn't see Jones coming from his left side at the end of the run. Watch, here's Wansley. He tries to make a move on Wansley. Now watch, right down there at the bottom there, that's where Jones caught him and pulled him backward. Hey, Stump Mitchell is a big play guy. He had a great game last week against the Giants. Running, throwing, threw for a touchdown pass.
Redskins lead 6-0. And here is what happens when they score first. They've won the last 22 times. We have 9:10 left to play in the first quarter. And the situation is Washington 6, St. Louis nothing. For the NFC Eastern Division Championship. Cardinals win, they're the champions. Redskins win, they're the champions. Cardinals lose, they're out. Redskins have clinched a wild card spot. From the 10, Lomax gets back to Anderson. Again, they go to the left side, and again, they get very little. Dave Butts was the first man there.
I'll tell you, you know, the other day, there was some talk that maybe the Redskins wouldn't be as fired up for this game because on Friday night, when the 49ers beat the Rams, and that put the Redskins in the playoff. So if they lose, they're still a wild card. When you talk to the players and the coaches yesterday at practice, they didn't believe any of that stuff. They said, we don't care what the heck. I mean, we still know we're playing a championship game tomorrow.
And because of, well, particularly Riggins' situation and his bad back, they'd like that week off, the layoff. Layoff before the playoff. Lomax out of the pocket. Going for Green, and if he's... Whew. Green had a couple of steps on Curtis Jordan. The ball had been there, that would have been 6.
Yeah, Roy Green is an amazing guy. He's one of the few guys that can run through a zone. You know, everyone says you can't get deep on a zone, you can't throw deep against a zone. Well, it all depends on who's throwing and who's running and who's catching, because this guy can't. He just runs. They have a safety sitting back there. He just runs right by him.
This guy is, for a person who started off as a defensive back, really developed into an outstanding and an extremely intelligent receiver. Stump Mitchell, the word is, has a thigh bruise, and whether or not he'll be back, we don't know. It's third down and 9 from the 11 for St. Louis, and they go into the shotgun formation. Redskins look like they might be bringing the blitzer. Lomax gets it out to Anderson. O.J. Anderson gets some clutch, tough yards before he's stopped by Rich Ballot. It's a Cardinal first down, 17-yard gain.
This is a thing that Neil Lomax was saying he has to do more, is have a little patience. If you're getting rushed, if they're coming, find the short guy. You see, Otis Anderson started to block there. He looked deep. He couldn't find anything. Didn't take the sack. Didn't force anything. Just found Anderson, gave it to him, and picked up a first down.
The
said before, you know, they went through a problem there where they had a lot of interceptions and turnovers. And he said he was just trying to force. He was just getting impatient. He said he feels that he's learned not to do that now.
Lone setback is Anderson. Lomax on a draw play. Nothing doing. Flags are down very quickly, way back deep. In the Redskins secondary, Darrell Grant was the first man. I think they might have let the 30-second clock expire.
Delay of game, number 15, offense, first down.
Let's check out what's happening. Cincinnati has come back to tie Buffalo at 7. Green Bay 10, Minnesota nothing. Tampa Bay 10, the New York Jets nothing. Cleveland 7, Houston nothing. All of those in the first quarter. It's also first quarter at RFK Stadium with the Redskins leading the Cardinals 6-0. First and 15. Lomax will throw it on first down. Outside to Anderson. Anderson hammers it up to the 30 before Dave Butts chases him down with help from Neil Oakowitz.
That's one of those things that the 49ers do so well on first down, using a run in lieu of a pass. You know, you want to get the ball to Otis Anderson, and you can run him inside or outside. And the third thing you can do is just throw a little loop to him. Of course, they'd like to pick up more than that. You'd like to pick up 5 or 6 yards on that on first down.
Well, they got, remember, they had a penalty on first down, so they got 7. So it's 2nd and 8.
That's what you like to get, about 7 yards on first
down. That's what you said.
Yeah.
Roy Green way out wide to the left. Nothing doing up the middle this time. Darrell Grant on the bottom of the pile again. It would seem that most of the light rain that was falling earlier has stopped.
Yeah, but that's good. I'd like to see a little rain out there. You know, look at Otis Anderson walking back. It's the first quarter. Look, he got mud on his pants and stuff. Running back. I mean, that's football to me. You know, the amazing thing. Look, I mean, some good dirt and mud. That's the way it should be. You know, the Cardinals, this is their 16th game, but it's only their 2nd game on grass all year.
Going for Green. The other Green was there with him, and there's no penalty call. Darrell Green was right back there with him, step for step.
I'm surprised at that one, that Roy Green didn't even complain, because watch Darrell Green's right hand there. He hit him there. That is interference right there. And then he comes in. Now he's trying to get his arm in there, but there's a double dipper there before the ball got there. They could have called Darrell Green on that
twice.
2 times.
Questionable. Mike Nelms back deep for the Redskins. Carl Birdsong putting for St. Louis. Good kick by Birdsong. Chases Nelms back to his 23-yard line. Hadn't been able to break much. Charlie Baker down to make the hit that stopped him, and the Cardinals have done a heck of a job in special teams in every category the last few weeks. In fact, Joe Gibbs said that the way they beat us the first time. Their special teams outplayed our special teams.
Every once in a while, something unexpected shows up.
Hey, what's that, a Toyota?
The 1985 Toyota Corolla GTS. A Toyota, dependable. A Corolla, affordable. A different kind of Corolla. A sleeper. A car for the street powered by a new twin cam, electronically fuel injected.
What's he got in there?
16-valve engine.
What's he got in there?
Known as the TC16.
Yeah, what's he got in there?
You know, a decent mechanic doesn't cut his teeth on rigs like that. I started out on pickups, then graduated to these babies. Now we got this place with 18-wheelers stopping in on the way to both coasts, because a trucker appreciates a quality job at a fair price. And so do I. That's why I like Meisterbrau. Oh, I could pay more for beer now, but this has full-bodied taste at a nice, easy price.
Hey, fellas, let's lock them up for the night.
Meisterbrau, big taste, without the big price.
A
legend fights for his life. Sunday on 60 Minutes.
Matt Summerall and John Madden, and we're at RFK Stadium in Washington, where the Redskins lead the Cardinals 6-0 with 5:48 left to play in the first quarter. Jim Hannifin, Cardinal coach, Monk in motion. Fake to Riggin. For Monk. Dropped it. Had it and dropped it. Incomplete. Lionel Washington was in the foot race. Wooden. It wasn't much of a race. Monk just blew it right by.
It looked like the ball could have been bobbled a little as he was running. You know, the jolting motion of the running looked like it bobbled the ball right out, because he just makes an up move. He goes right by Lionel Washington. Look, and the ball is right there. He has it under control, but it looked like as he was moving, he could just never get control of it down low. I mean, but he had caught the pass, it looked like.
Like he was trying to make the adjustment after he caught it. He just couldn't hang on. Cardinals dodge a bullet. Monk is out wide to the right again. Calvin Mohammed to the left. Don't be surprised to see Theismann go again, is what I was about to say to Mohammed. That's incomplete. Jeff Griffin was the nearest defender. Joe Washington comes in and Riggins comes out.
You know, the interesting thing about that play, Pat, it was an audible by Joe Theismann. The Redskins call the plays from the sidelines, very little audibilizing. In fact, when Joe Theismann says yellow 30, that means nothing. That's just a dummy call. That time he went 0-22 because he saw a safety blitz, and that meant the slant to Mohammed.
Monk comes out to the left this time. Mohammed is to the right. That's Didier on the move. To work it back the other way, and they get a first down. Lionel Washington was a defender, a gain of 15.
Watch Calvin Mohammed. He's starting out on the right side now. He's going to run an in pattern right in here towards us. He comes down. Joe Theismann hits him right on the move. I don't know that I've seen Joe Theismann start as hot as he is today. Let's watch Curtis Greer and Joe Jacoby here. As I said, now what Curtis Greer is trying to do is just run right by him. And Joe Jacoby is just trying to take his momentum and push him beyond the quarterback.
Riggins is back, and here he goes. He doesn't go very far. Maybe got back to the line of scrimmage before E.J. Jr. and Charlie Baker. You're talking about the little rain and mud. E.J. Jr. said he really liked that. We talked with him last night.
Hey, he said that's the way it should be. He remembered back to high school games he played on grass, you know. As I said, the Cardinals have only played, this is only their second game all year. And he said it's really going to be nice to get out there, be a middle linebacker. He said guys like Butkus and Nitschke and Sam Huff and those guys.
He's going to the Pro Bowl. Started the year playing outside linebacker and then moved into the middle. So this is just his fifth game in the middle. And here it comes. They get it outside to Don Warren. A pickup of only about three before Thomas Howard takes him down. Junior was on a blitz that time.
Yeah, I was saying earlier what a game Joe Theismann was having, because you take the one touchdown pass he's thrown, Art Monk drops another one, and then Calvin Mohammed drops one on him. He could be very close to perfect in this game.
Third down and about eight. Washington comes in for Riggins. Joe Washington, that is. Didier moves again. Pressure. Theismann gets out of it. Theismann gets almost completely out of it. He is hammered by Thomas Howard.
I don't know how he gets up after some of those hits, because that happened to him all last week, and he just seems to be built out of rubber or something. He just gets hit and bounces up. Watch him here. David Galloway is the first guy. He gets here. Theismann gets away. Bubba Baker has him by the jersey. He gets away from that. And then look at the hits that he takes right there at the end of it. Thomas Howard's going to be the guy coming in at the end. He's darn near going without a jersey. They make give, it out there.
Excuse me, John. They give Baker the credit for the sack. He's the one who ripped the jersey off. But Galloway was the man who chased him out of the pocket. Hayes hangs it high. Danny Pittman lets it bounce. It goes out of bounds at about the 22-yard line where the Cardinals will take over. 33-yard punt, no return. 2:44 left to play in the first quarter with the Redskins up by 6 over St. Louis.
Blue GCA, this is Army 212, 7 miles northwest, low fuel, heavy weather.
Army 212 radar contact, turn right heading 150.
With a fog-bound helicopter hanging on your every word, it doesn't matter whether you're a man or a woman, only that you're
coming
good.
Up slowly.
Roger.
Overlanding threshold.
Be all that you can be.
Thanks for your help.
Roger.
You can do it in the Army.
No matter what unexpected problem should arise, Transamerica Property, Casualty, and Life Insurance can be there to protect you.
Hey, you big ape! Who's gonna pay for this mess?
Transamerica. Insurance, finance, manufacturing, transportation, innovation. The power of the pyramid is working for you.
You know, I've heard of guys being held together by a shoestring, but here's Theismann.
Well, you know, he got his jersey ripped there, and they don't have a lot of materials down there like needles and threads and that stuff, so they're trying to sew it back together with a shoestring. Look at that. More things you can do. Theismann saying, get me back together. I got to play when we get the ball again. Hurry up. That's what they say.
O.J. Anderson with a runner. They get it to Farrell. Lomax does. Farrell gets outside the 35 to the 37. Olkowitz and Malott converge after a gain of 16.
It's an interesting thing here, you know, picking up a 16 yards on that play. It's the type of thing that I think Lomax is really learning. You see again here, he's trying to go deep. You see, he tried to go to the right, tried to go to the left. Now, instead of forcing something, he says, okay, I'll just dump it off right here to Earl Farrell and still get 16 yards.
And he gives most of that credit to his coach, Rod Dauhauer. He said, before, I dropped 3 yards, 8 yards, 5 yards, rolled out, sprinted out, whatever I wanted to do. Now, it's discipline. Lomax back to throw. Got it to Green. Green about, looks like he's very close to a first down. Okay. Darryl Green on the stop, excuse me.
That's going to be an interesting matchup all day because Darryl Green was telling us that wherever Roy Green goes, I'm going to cover him. Both of them were selected to the Pro Bowl this week, so they're both Pro Bowl players going one-on-one against each other. Now, that's a pretty good match within a good match, you know what I mean? A game within a game.
They're both refreshing guys to talk to, aren't they?
Well, they are, and they play refreshing. They have a lot of life in them, a lot of bounce in them. And did you see that yardstick down there? That looked like that. That was taped together.
Well, it's the 16th game.
No, it looked like Theismann jersey. It looked like something George Preston Marshall brought here with him in the Redskins.
That gets where Theismann got his jersey.
I like those old things. That's good. You know, get it back to what it was.
Maybe that's why we get along. Anderson over the right side on first down. Dexter Manley on the bottom of the pile, but Anderson got about 4 or 5.
I'll tell you, he's a big guy, isn't he, that Otis Anderson? He's one of those. Most halfbacks try and juke you or run around you. Otis Anderson is one that loves to punish you, to run over, to find a guy, a safety, that he can hit and hurt. I guess when they played Philadelphia, they had a real thing. You know, they have up there Wes Hopkins as the hard-hitting safety. Every time Anderson would break in the clear, he'd try and find Hopkins to run over.
Second down and 5. Relax out to Anderson. Faced by Malott. Fumble. The Redskins have come up with it. Vernon Dean. Close to midfield, but the Redskins have the ball. Rich Malott, I think, made the hit that caused the fumble, and Dean is limping off.
chances. It's the same type of thing. Lomax again dumps off to Otis Anderson. He's dangerous in the open field. Starts to make a move just as he gets hit on the left shoulder by Monty Coleman. The ball bounces out. Vernon Dean picks it up. Stepped out of bounds right there. So they blew the whistle. Every time you start to talk about a guy, something happens to him all the time, like Otis Anderson, and he fumbled. But that's really hurt the Cardinals all year, is turnovers.
They went through a series of 3 weeks where they averaged about six a week. They can do anything wrong. Heisman back to throw and goes down the middle of Monk. Monk with about a 9-yard pickup. Benny Perrin and Lionel Washington. This is Vernon Dean. They're looking at his right ankle. That turnover business we were just talking about. Well, they lost to Dallas and to the Rams and to the Giants. They were a serious problem. Then they cut them down and they started to win again.
That's the thing. And then you play the Redskins and you really can't have turnovers against the Redskins because they're so opportunistic. You know, anytime they get one, they usually get a score with it.
Ask Dallas about it after last week. That's the end of the first quarter. With the score, the Redskins leading the Cardinals by the score of 6-0.
When I launched this business a few years back,
we were building mostly skiffs and dinghies.
Now look what we're putting in the water. You know why this yacht caught on? Because we do a good job at a fair price.
We like Meisterbrau for the same reason.
Sure, we could pay more for beer now. But this is a big, full-bodied taste without a big price.
Fellas, drop anchor right here.
Meisterbrau, big taste without the big price.
When they put a heavy load on your shoulders, there's nothing like having a friend you can count on. The new Toyota electronically fuel-injected one-ton truck. It'll carry over 2,500 pounds. And with an optional towing package, you can pull up to 5,000 pounds. The Toyota one-ton truck.
Thanks, old buddy.
Oh, 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 what a feeling. Toyota.
When IBM personal computer owners look for good software, where can they turn? To IBM for programs that help you keep up with modern times. Business programs, entertainment, productivity, education, and more. The variety you want with the quality you expect in the growing library of IBM personal computer software. A well-balanced selection at a store near you.
Second quarter about to get underway. Pat Summerall and John Madden. Redskins and the Cardinals for the NFC Eastern Division Championship. They give to Riggins. Riggins barrels over the right side, gets a first down inside the Cardinal 40. David Galloway picked him up and put him down.
There's a guy that's an underrated player, I think, is David Galloway. You know, he plays that right tackle there for the Cardinals, and he's a great big strong guy. And I was talking yesterday to Russ Grimm about him. Just watch him in there. He's right over the center there. And Grimm said, you know, he's one of those guys that you have to go all day against. He said he has a motor that runs about 110 miles an hour. I like that. Yeah, motors run fast. Good motor.
Russ Grimm has one of those motors. Here's Riggins again behind Jacoby and Grimm. By the Cardinals, but gets down to about the 31-yard line.
Talk about Russ Grimm. Watch the play that he makes on Thomas Howard. He's number 68 in the white. Now watch him. He's pulling right here. Now watch. Here's a way to pull and block someone. Just knock them right on their back and then let the big diesel run right by you. Now that's a block. That's the way pulling guards should pull. That's the way they should block when they get there. They're going, boom!
Get behind those two guys, you're getting behind 600 pounds. Second and two on the 32. Theismann fakes to Riggins and takes off with it himself, and Theismann sprints out of bounds at the 25 with a first down.
All the other Redskins are walking back to the huddle, and they're all talking about that. What they were saying, what did he do? Did you see it? I'm sure that Joe Theismann didn't tell anyone around that.
That's when that play is most effective.
Watch that. He'll just fake it. You see that? They all think he's going. Oh, no. He just missed the handoff. He didn't tell him. Riggins wasn't tight enough. He started to hand to him to the right. He wasn't there, so he just kept it and went the other way. Because I knew those linemen didn't know where Theisman was. They were like, hey, what happened? Where'd he go? How'd he get over there?
Well, you know, Riggins didn't practice except the walkthrough yesterday. So maybe he just missed it. Munkin comes back to his right. Theisman goes to it. Not much yardage, but another completion. Wayne Smith on the tackle.
You know, Charlie Hennigan, who has the reception record of all time that Art Monk is trying to break today, said one thing that he likes about Monk. He said, if someone's going to break it, he would like to see him break it because he's playing and winning games. He's playing for championships. He's playing in big games. And if you can do it under those situations, you deserve the record.
He needs three to set the record and pass Charlie Hennigan. Second down at six. It was intended for Monk. Lionel Washington was out there with him.
Art Monk was complaining about something, but Lionel Washington was beaten by Monk, but he was just able to get between Theisman and Monk. Now watch Monk. He's the inside guy, and he's saying he grabbed him there. He did. He grabbed his jersey. Watch his right shoulder pad. You see it there? Look. That's what Monk's saying. Look, he grabbed my jersey right off the shoulder pad, Rap.
Well, he had evidence.
He did. He went right into the jersey.
No fingerprints, but evidence. Third down and six, and Joe Washington is in instead of Riggins. Didier in motion. Theisman retreats. He has Calvin Muhammad for a Redskin first down. Jeff Griffin was a defender, a gain of 10. They move down to the Cardinal 12-yard line.
Watch Muhammad now. He knows how much he has to get for a first down. You see him get that right arm up to knock Griffin off and then just run the out pattern on him. But he knew how much he had to get. He got beyond the first down marker, and then he threw the right arm, boom, knocked off Griffin, and then ran an out pattern.
Calvin Muhammad is a player, obviously, but he has a chance to be very, very good.
Bill Gibbs said if you'd watch him now, you think he's a first-round draft choice.
Riggins to the left. Hit behind the line of scrimmage and just about got back that far. Ramsey Dardar hit him first, and he got an assist from David Galloway.
I'll tell you one thing about that Cardinal defense, and Riggins is going to know it at the end of this game, too. They have a real tough middle. David Galloway, Ramsey Dardar, and E.J. Jr. play that middle strong.
Elois Grooms has come in to play in the middle now. Ramsey Dardar is out. Go with a three down lineman set up, and now they put another man down. Theisman back to throw. Cardinals out of left, it's Monk. Into the end zone, touchdown. His second of the day.
Kicker, so the point will count, and the penalty then would go on the kickoff. That would be an interesting thing if it's a 15-yard penalty. Let's watch Art Monk again. Joe Theismann is watching to his right all the way. He finds Monk, the short guy, hits him. Monk knows where that end zone, and he just turns right up there, makes one little move, and the ball breaks the play. Watch him here. He's Lionel Washington is number 48. Monk starts in a short motion, stops, makes a move on Washington. He can't recover, gets back to the outside.
It's
a tough thing for Washington. Watch him. He got beat for the touchdown, and he's the guy that they called the penalty on right there for roughing Mark Mosley. It's a double different, two for two.
Redskins up 13 to nothing now with 11:54 left in the first half.
Over the years, a lot of small businesses have developed their own systems of communicating.
Henderson! Yes, sir. Eric, talk to Derek.
But now, there's a better way. Meet the Merlin system from AT&T. Merlin's a telephone, an intercom, a conference caller, and has dozens of features you can select.
Henderson.
So yes, Merlin can grow as your small business grows. Call about Merlin. AT&T Information Systems, when you've got to be right.
Some make greatness look simple, like superstar Larry Bird and the Canon T70. Covering Bird with the simplicity of touch-button controls. Countering his quickness with automatic film advance. Capturing any shot with the versatility of three program modes, the Canon T70. And it's so simple.
Watch the bird.
The Canon T70, it makes the great shots simple.
13-0, the Redskins scoring drive, 9 plays, 52 yards, they kept it 3 minutes and 48 seconds. Art Monk with 2 touchdown catches from Kaiser. Jeff Hayes drills it to Danny Pittman, who's going to bring it out or try to. Pittman outside the 20, about the 22. Anthony Jones was down to make the stop. Down 13-0 will operate from their own 22-yard line. They got to get something going. That Redskin offense over on the bench. Riggins with a little oxygen.
That was Don Bro, the running back coach here. He's trying to talk to him, and Riggins is trying to get oxygen. See, that's kind of put in priority. You get the oxygen before you listen to the coach, but you don't do both.
On first down goes to Green. Steps out of bounds after a pickup of about 8. Darryl Green was over there. Cincinnati has taken the lead over Buffalo 14-7. Second quarter, they need it. Chicago 7, Detroit 3. That's also in the second quarter. The Cardinal defense, that's their coach Floyd Peters.
Tell you, Floyd Peters is one of the top defensive line coaches in this league. Wherever he goes, he always has a four-man line and a very active four-man line.
Second and two as Farrell is in front of Anderson, and Anderson swings over to the right side. Close to a first down before Charles Mann, the left defensive end for the Redskins, takes him down.
Now, one thing the Cardinals talked about last night is being in a big game like this and not having been in one for a long time, that they were worried that they may start off a little nervous. You know, the crowd, this whole scene here in Washington. But if that were true, they should be working themselves out of it by now.
They better. Dexter Manley, they bring the chains out to measure. Looks like he might be a little bit short.
Yeah, that's short.
Not much. About a foot. 140 consecutive sellouts they've had since 1966. Stadium opened in 1961.
I'll tell you one thing about these people here. Not only do they all show up and fill all those seats, but they know what to do when they get here. They're good rooters.
With a lot of enthusiasm, third and short. Randy Love is in the game now in front of Anderson. The give is to Anderson. I don't know if he got it or not. I don't think so.
I'm sure he didn't get it, Pat. The Redskins, the right side of the defense of the Redskins really got too much penetration.
It was Tom Beasley who made the initial hit, and look at those fans you were talking about.
Oh, yeah. This place will shake sometime today. Tom Beasley, Rich Millard on that side. Beasley goes in for Dexter Manley. You see the penetration there? You see the white jerseys got on the other side of the Cardinal jerseys, and there was no place for Otis Anderson to go.
They just speed him at the offensive line. Line of scrimmage.
You can't have penetration on short yardage.
Birdsong back to punt, and Elms back deep to the Redskins. Shank off the side of his foot and fielded. Only about 10 yards down the field by Greg Williams. That's about the worst kick I ever saw.
I've never seen a punt like that. That's a playground punt. That thing was just a line drive. Williams was just a blocker. He wasn't even a punt returner. That's worse than a shank. Watch this thing. It's a line drive. It's just going to barely get over the offensive line. Watch him. That thing just goes like a little line drive to third base. Williams like the third baseman. You know, it looked like just before he kicked the ball, he kind of stepped his toe. Watch him. Just before he kicks it. You see the right foot? Yeah, it looked like he got a hunk of dirt, like a shank. You know how you, in golf, you hit behind the thing?
Hit it fat.
Yeah, that's what I do.
You don't get much yardage that way.
Birdsong got a either. Fat one.
I have taken on many fighters and tried many beers. One beer isn't a class by itself. Light beer from Miller. Light tastes great, and it's less filling. It weighs in at a third less calories than the regular beer. Yes. I discovered your greatest beer, but I never met your greatest fighter. Hey, who is this Billy Martin anyway?
Billy Martin? He's warm, he's gentle, good looking too.
I got to meet this guy.
Blake Beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Pontiac.
When you get a Pontiac Sunbird, you get a car that's practical and easy to own. When you get a Pontiac Sunbird, you get a car that's technically advanced and carefully built. When you get a Pontiac Sunbird, you can also get a car with 150 turbocharged horsepower. If you're so inclined. Sunbird, only from Pontiac.
We build excitement.
Pontiac.
Monday.
My wife is a compulsive gambler.
A housewife in too deep. Can Cagney and Lacey find her before loan sharks out for blood money?
If you don't, she won't be worth fighting.
Monday.
Jeff Bostic. The injured Redskin center who went to the Pro Bowl last year hurt his knee against the Cardinals in their first meeting, and there's his brother, Joe Bostic.
His mother and father are in the stands. I asked his father yesterday who he's going to root for. He said, it depends where I am. He was at the Redskin practice. He's wearing a Redskin hat. He goes to the Cardinal practice, wears a Cardinal hat. Doesn't tell anyone who he really roots for.
That's Monk in motion as they go from the Cardinal 44 and go for more. It's for Monk. Almost intercepted by Lee Nelson, who got over to help out Lionel Washington. And he's going to need some help with Art Monk.
Lee Nelson had a good read on that. He was over there. I don't know that Joe Theismann saw him coming. And the ball was right in his hands. He just dropped that one. That's why he's shaking his head. He don't get too many of those opportunities.
Second and 10 as you look at the massive hands and arms of Dave Butts. 6'7 and 295.
I'll tell you, he's happy today. You know why? Because it's cold. Big guys like cold weather.
Second down. Didier in motion. Blitz is on, and Theismann saw it coming. To Muhammad, who hangs on. Short of a first down, gain of 9, Wayne Smith on the tackle. It'll be third and short, about 1.
You know, the guy who does a good job there is John Riggins. We'll see Junior. He's the guy right here. He's going to be blitzing, but watch John Riggins right here. He makes a good block. On the outside guy, you see Nelson coming, and then Junior goes in the middle. They had a double blitz, they had the linebacker and safety coming, and they picked him up.
Wansley comes to the right this time, and Riggins will probably go in that direction. And he does, and gets the first down. Kurt Allerman made the initial hit. It's close, but I'm pretty sure he got it.
wonder if they don't have it. I wonder what Joe Gibbs will do.
They're very efficient on fourth and short.
I don't think they have it.
He wants to go for it. He wants to go for it. They're going to measure. And if you have Riggins, I think you've got a pretty good chance.
Watch this. It just depends on where that guy put his foot down there. Someday they're going to have that thing that I said, that beam that gets away. One of the Cardinal players is down there holding the ball. Look at Joe. He's going to go for it. Yeah, he says go. What the heck? I got Riggins. Again, he'll go. He'll run Riggins. He'll run him to the left side behind Jacoby and Grimm.
Fourth and just a couple of inches. They have converted on fourth down 11 out of 14 times when they've tried. Theismann asks for quiet. Wansley moves to the left. Riggins moves up. And he moves up a little more. It's close. It's still going to be close as Benny Perrin cut him down.
I don't think he made it from here. Because he had it. He couldn't get in there. He had a bounce to the outside. And when he bounced to the outside, Benny Perrin, the free safety, was able to get up and tackle him in the open field. That's not a first down. In fact, they're not even going to measure it. Now watch it here. He's going to start to the left side. You see, starting here. Couldn't find any hole in there. Watch 23. Benny Perrin come up. Now that's a heck of a tackle for a little guy.
Joe Gibbs' reaction. Come on, John. And now the statistic is 11 out of 15 instead of 14. 9:07 left to play in the first half.
At a recent wine tasting near Rome, some restaurateurs discovered a special American wine.
Elegant.
They thought it excellent.
Buono.
And they tried to guess its price. Most guessed between $7 and $10. Except for one.
Not even $3.
Who was the judge who knew the wine did not cost $7 to $10? Francesco Giambelli, who had served the wine at his famous restaurant in New York, Gallo Chablis Blanc. From Ernest and Giulio Gallo, all the best.
Pontiac.
It's brand new. It's from Pontiac, and it's called Grand Am. The latest in Pontiac road car technology, Grand Am is a true driver's coupe. That means it's built for drivers who appreciate engineering excellence as well as exciting road machinery. You know who you are. Grand Am, new from Pontiac, only from Pontiac.
We build excitement.
Pontiac.
We'd like to remind you that next Saturday there's NCAA basketball on CBS Sports. UCLA, coached by former Bruins star Walt Hazard, will go to Madison Square Garden to play the Redmen of St. John's and Lou Carnesecca. Get a look at a couple of great players, Chris Mullen and Walter Berry. We're looking at a lot of great players right here. One who just made a great play was the man you just saw, Benny Perrin.
He was checking his nostrils out, see if he still had everything in there.
Manley after Lomax. Roy Green has got it, stays on his feet. Cut down finally by Ken Coffey. But it's a Cardinal first down and a pickup of 24.
That's one thing the Cardinals are going to have to do to win this game and to get back into the game. They have to get the ball into player in the hands of their best player, and it's this guy, Roy Green. Watch the way he comes down the field, puts pressure on the defense, makes them get back, catches the ball, gets off a couple of tacklers, and finally gets knocked down by the third.
I thought it was interesting, John, when you asked him last night if there was any pattern when he didn't make some kind of an adjustment, and he said there's only one, and that's a fly pattern.
He said every other pattern, he has four possible adjustments.
Anderson over the right side, cuts to the line of scrimmage, might have picked up a yard, and it was a tough yard as Darrell Grant was there to cut him down.
You know, the other thing you're talking about, Roy Green, is it's amazing to me how fresh he is. You know, here it is, the 16th game of the season. Of course, it's a big game, but you see him running down the field. He looked like a deer.
He can really run.
And it's not easy to play in 16 games, but to stay fresh for 16 games is darn near impossible.
Money's a factor, but you got to enjoy the game to do that.
a lot of ability.
Second and nine from the Redskin 40 for the Cardinals at Lomax. Like he expected, Fritz. He got more than that. Darryl Grant was there first. Dexter Manley was there second.
That looked like an awfully slow setting up draw. We'll see from the left side of the screen, we'll see the Redskins were in a stunt. Darryl Grant going to the outside, Manley coming to the inside, and the draw didn't fool them at all. They just ran right into it.
Charles Mann also got a piece of the action. Manley was there first. Mann was there about the same time. As they go shotgun on third and 13 from the Redskin 44. Lomax gets it out to Anderson. And there's nothing there. And the Redskin defense one more time rises to the occasion.
I'll tell you, the Cardinals had great pass protection on that play. Neil Lomax had all day, but the Redskins had better pass defense downfield. There was no rush at all on Lomax. No one was getting there, but he didn't have anyone open. Everyone was covered downfield, and he had to throw the ball off to O.J. Anderson.
Birdsong will hope to better his last effort. Elms is back deep for the Redskins at the 10. High snap. Birdsong comes down with it. Gets off a high kick. Angling out of bounds. Yeah, what a kick. Boy, he made some amends. Birdsong knocks it dead at the 1 yard line. 43 yard punt and no return. He'll feel better. 13-0 Washington.
Did you hear AT&T has introduced something rather radical? The Reach Out America plan. Calling anywhere in the United States weekends and nights is just $10 an hour. The next is even less. So you can see how far your money goes. Quite ingenious, really. They even have a number for ordering. 1-800-551-3131. Reach Out America. They may be on to something.
AT&T. The more you hear, the better we sound.
Wednesday, Goldie Hawn joins the Army.
Is green the only color these come in?
And it's a question of who surrenders first, the Army or...
Private Benjamin Day!
Wednesday.
That Stump Mitchell, who was hit on a kickoff return earlier. Our information was it was a bruised thigh. I don't want to be pessimistic, John, but that looks like it might be more than a bruised thigh.
I would think so. At least they're going to check something that could be more than a bruised thigh. Of course, they can take him into the locker room now and x-ray him. They have x-ray machines right here in the site.
Redskins from their own one, and Riggins pounds to about the two, and E.J. Jr. is there to take him down.
I'll tell you, the Cardinals are doing a good job on stopping Riggins. Up until that carry, he carried 10 times for 22 yards. The last three carries, he hadn't gained a yard. Watch number 54, E.J. Jr. there. He's keying on Riggins. He goes parallel. When he goes parallel, he finds a little hole in there and just sneaks in, gets a hunk of him, and then all his buddies come and jump on him.
Second down and nine. 5:48 left to play in the first half. Heisman going to work. It's picked off. Wayne Smith picks it off. And the Cardinals. Touchdown. The officials haven't signaled yet. They say no. Calvin Muhammad was the intended receiver. The Cardinals will have it first and goal at about the 1 foot line. Clint Didier is injured. 12 yard return to the 1 yard line. That can turn things around.
That's a dangerous pass down there. Wayne Smith really got a jump on it. A Let's watch it here. He's the defender at the top there, the defender at the top of the screen. Watch him. He's looking at him. Here comes Muhammad in the slant. Now that really wasn't a very good throw. I mean, it was just thrown in front of him and over his head. Muhammad looked like he was covered all around and wasn't sure exactly where to go. Now Theismann knows that once you throw an interception, you have to go and try and tackle the guy.
Muhammad, I think that was just a mix-up between Theismann and Muhammad, because Muhammad started to stop and then started again. It happened to Duck Donnelly last week. I think it was just a misread.
I think so, because that's one of the problems they've been having all year with Muhammad and Theismann, is not really getting each other's reads properly.
In any case, the Cardinals have a first down at the Redskin 1-foot line. 5:37 left to play first half, and the Cardinals trying to get back in the contest. Lomax gets it into the end zone. Touchdown, St. Louis.
I'll tell you one thing. There's a couple things that are going to come back to haunt the Redskins. One is the missed extra point. Two was going hard on fourth down and not getting it. And now three is that interception. And two of those things work together.
Jim Hanifin recaptures some enthusiasm for this contest. Neil O'Donohue. The holder is Benny Parent. A very, very important extra point this might turn out to be. O'Donohue gets it over the net and over everything. And it's 13-7.
Let's watch this play right here again. Now, here's Muhammad here. Here's Wayne Smith here. He's going to come in and run a slant. Now, it looks like he's confused in here. Wayne Smith gets a jump on the ball and takes it down to the one-yard line. Watch Muhammad there. He's the outside guy. Now he comes in. You see him, but he kind of stops there. It looks like Theismann was leading him in. Wayne Smith saw it. Muhammad didn't.
And that mistake led to the touchdown. It puts the Cardinals closer. It's 13-7.
Pontiac.
The editors of Road and Track call the Pontiac 6000 STE one of the world's 12 best enthusiast cars. Car and Driver called the Pontiac 6000 STE one of the 10 best cars of 1984. So why did we make it even better for 1985? Just because. The sensational 6000. Only from Pontiac.
We build excitement.
Pontiac.
I don't compete anymore, but I still pump iron. So after lifting a few hundred pounds, it's nice to lift one of these. Light beer from Miller. Light tastes great, and it's less filling, with a third less calories than the regular beer. Now, you know, bodybuilding is hard work, but having a great body has its advantages. Sure makes it easy to pick up guys. Hi, Rodney.
Oh, hi there. What's going on here? Hey, honey, how about a lift home, huh?
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer. And less.
A little bit more interesting now. Washington 13, St. Louis 7. Second quarter we are. O'Donohue set to kick off, and Mike Nelms will be back deep for the Redskins. O'Donohue, a high kick. It's Keith Griffin instead of Nelms. And Griffin gets it out to the 30. Good running by Keith Griffin. Dave Ahrens again on the tackle, a 21-yard return. Griffin was injured on the opening kickoff. Didn't look like he'd be back, but he is.
Now, I'll tell you one thing about this game so far. It's really not much of a running game. Washington has run 12 for 29 yards, 2.4 average. St. Louis has run 10 times for 8 yards, 0.8 per carry. Not a big running game on the grass. Mud, dirt, run.
5:25 left to play first half. 13-7 Redskins. Monk moves in motion. Theismann going back to work. And going deep for Calvin Muhammad, who's got it. Wayne Smith back there with him, the guy who made the interception. Goes from champion to victim. 60 yards.
One that Joe Theismann doesn't have any problems with Calvin Muhammad on him. This is just go. You run by Wayne Smith, Calvin. Run as fast as you can. I'll lay it out. Lay it out in front of you. You catch it and keep running until you get to about the 10-yard line. That works. That's better than that slant coming off the goal line.
No mistakes and no reads there.
Just run fast. I'll throw long.
It's first and goal at the 10. The Hammocks caught four. 93 yards. Riggins. Didier's back in the game. And let's see who starts in motion quickly. Almost a touchdown, and there's the flag down. It was intended for Art Monk. Lionel Washington was the defender.
That'll put the ball right down on the goal line. If that's interference against the Cardinals.
Holding.
Now, that's only a 5-yard penalty. That's what Phil Gibbs is saying. Where are we now?
That'll make it first and
goal.
Number 48.
From five. Defense. Automatic first down.
Automatic first down at the 5. Take the Redskins long to get back, did it?
Well, it doesn't when you have a guy like Art Monk on one side, Calvin Muhammad on the other side, a big offensive line, and a guy throwing it like Joe Theismann's throwing it.
Washington has not been penalized at all, by the way. The Cardinals 4 times for 25 yards. 5 clutch ones right there. 4:39 left to play. The handoff is to Riggins. And the Diesel is in the end zone. Point with Theismann holding. It's good. 70 yards in 2 plays.
Watch this counter play. Riggins takes a little step to the left. Grimm pulls, buries his guy. Jacoby pulls. He follows them both in from the right side this time. They can run to the left side behind him. But watch it here. Now they pull both the left guard and left tackle. Right here. Now this guy, Riggins, he takes a little step here, a little counter, then right back in behind the two big guys from the left side. Watch, you see the little counter step? Grimm in front first, big Jacoby coming around second, big Riggins coming around third, and into the end zone.
Grimm and Jacoby both got good blocks, and Riggins broke 2 tackles. Christmas Day on CBS Sports, we'll have a football-basketball doubleheader for you. First at 12:30 Eastern, the College All-Stars will play in the 47th annual Blue-Gray Football Classic. Then after that, at 3:30 Eastern time, the NBA on CBS returns with a matchup of Eastern Conference Powers. The 76ers and the Pistons. Danny Pittman on the return for the Cardinals. Pittman to the 25. Anthony Jones doing a good job on special teams again today. Makes the stop. There's Riggins.
And there's a fullback. You got that. You got a little sweat on you, towel over your head. You don't shave. You don't shave to play. Have a jacket on. It's not ripped anymore. Just finish the oxygen after you get a touchdown. Little smile. You don't keep it there long, no. Fullback.
Not a long smile.
No. Short one. Just real like that.
20-7. 4:24 left in the first half at RFK. Lomax going to work, or hoping to. Gets it out to Anderson outside the 30. Pickup of about 6. Mel Coughlin stopped him.
There's a typical defensive player. See, look, you got mud. Now, you don't want too much mud on your back. You don't want, you like to have it on your front where you're giving it to him, but you got mud there, you know, and the things and the pads and all that stuff. But you don't want too much on the back.
Well, it's tougher for us if you got mud on the back. You've got a few threads hanging down there, too.
Foul.
is to Farrell this time. He is hammered by Darryl Grant and a couple of other Redskins. Rich Mullott. Boy, they fired up.
They ran right into a stun on that one. Dexter Manley comes inside. Darryl Grant comes to the outside right around Manley. And when you run into a Darryl Grant, you're running into a 280-pound load. He is a load.
He plays on special teams and everything. They can't get him off.
Joe Gibbs will never forget the first day he came to the camp. He got hit, lifted weights, cut his whole forehead open, came back in the afternoon to lift again wearing a helmet.
Lomax under pressure by Perry Brooks. In the grasp and down, and a sack by Perry Brooks. The Redskins second of the day. They may be in the playoffs, but they are fired up.
They want to come into playoffs through the front door. You know, last week, Perry Brooks had one in the grasp against the Cowboys. Perry Brooks is a right tackle. They blew the whistle, but Danny White threw an interception. And I said, that's one time Perry Brooks didn't want a sack. He told me yesterday, he said, yeah, I did want the sack. Yeah, he said, I wanted it. I was yelling for the sack, not the interception. That's the way defensive linemen think.
Herzog back to punt. Nils back to catch. Block! Rich Marty blocked it and picked it up. He was great on special teams for New Orleans, and the crowd really is into it now.
Pat, and he looked like he took it right off of his toe. He's right here. Yeah, now he's right here. Now he comes out, but he comes inside right here, and he looks like he takes it right off Birdsong's toe. Watch him, he comes inside right there. Now he took it right off his foot.
They go to work. Theismann does quickly. Lays it outside of Didier. Incomplete. Smith was the defender out there with it.
Let's watch Marty again. See, fake to the outside, came to the inside. Now watch your block. He gets both hands up. Just as it leaves Birdsong's foot, he picks it right off there, knocks it down. Now he comes over and recovers it. Well, I'll tell you, you know, you don't think a lot about special teams, but they can make so doggone many big plays for you throughout a season.
As I said, he was great on special teams for New Orleans before he came here. Second down from the nine. Theismann looking. Theismann hustling to the right side, chased by Baker. Fakes. Theismann himself gets down inside the five.
Clint Didier fell into a block on that play. Clint Didier was trying to get open, and one of the Cardinals came over and knocked Didier down, and it turned into a block for Theismann. Let's watch Didier on this play. Look, he starts out helping on Bubba Baker. Now he sees that there's a little trouble there, so he wants to be a receiver. Now watch, he's trying to get open. The guy hits him, knocks him down. Theismann sees it. He thinks it's a block, so he runs off it.
Not bad. David Galloway, he shielded off. Goal from the four. Didier lines up in front of Riggins, and now he moves. Theismann looks in his direction. Theismann met by E.J. Jr. And he takes him down at the five, and we will probably see Mark Mosley.
Can you believe Joe Theismann on that play? He tried to cut back and stiff arm on E.J. Jr.
That's confidence.
That is confidence. Well, no, that's overconfidence. When you're the quarterback, you just want to get down. But watch Theismann here. I think he wants to go out here to Didier. He gets the blitz by Nelson. Now watch him here. He starts to look. He put his left. He was going to straight arm him, like those old pictures you used to have.
Didn't work. Posing for the Heisman Trophy, maybe. 20-7 with 2 minutes left first half.
This NFL Most Valuable Player segment is brought to you by IBM. 1971. Quarterback Bob Greasy, in a run-oriented offense, throws for 19 touchdowns and leads the Miami Dolphins to a 10-3-1 record and their first ever Super Bowl appearance. At season's end, Greasy is named the league's most valuable player.
Morning, Miss Stevens.
Good morning.
Mr. Lewis.
After you buy IBM equipment for your business, we don't stop trying to make it even better. And if we make an engineering change, as part of our maintenance agreement, an IBM service representative will stop by and make the change.
You ask it. Good as new?
Better than new.
Our service representatives don't just keep your machines running.
Take care.
They make your machines run better.
He said it was better than new.
Think he can fix a 53 Studebaker?
IBM.
20-7, the Redskins over the Cardinals with 2 minutes left in the first half. Mosley is on for a field goal of 21 yards, I'm sorry. He's 21 out of 28 on the year. Theismann will hold. Mosley got it. And it's 23-7 in favor of the Redskins. Other scores around the league. We'll have an opportunity to check right now. Cincinnati in command in that situation. They need to win, and Pittsburgh needs to lose later on this afternoon. The Bears 14-6 over Detroit now in the second quarter. Green Bay mopping up with Minnesota 31-0. 17-7, the Buccaneers over the Jets. John McKay's last game as the NFL head coach of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. New England 13, Indianapolis nothing. Cleveland 10, Houston 7 at the half. At RFK, it's 23-7. The Redskins over the Cardinals for the NFC Eastern Championship. Cardinals win, they're the champions. Redskins hold on and win, they're the champions. And get a week off. And the Cardinals will get a week off, too. This is Danny Pittman at the 5. Pittman to about the 26 before he's cut down by the Redskins. Pete Cronin, the captain of their special teams. St. Louis has a minute 53 left on the clock. They have all of their timeouts remaining. So does Washington. Go back and replay this first half. There have been a lot of crucial things and critical things have happened.
And a lot of those things also happened against the Redskins, but again, being the championship type, the championship team, the experience in those types of things, they've been able to play themselves out of it.
Cardinals operate with three wide receivers. Neil Lomax can't find him. Spins it out to O.J. Anderson. And Anderson whirls up close to midfield. Out of bounds at the 46 by Vernon Dean.
That's what I was talking about. Otis Anderson there, the way he finishes off a run. He knew that he was going to go out of bounds, but before he did, he wanted to take a shot here on Vernon Dean. But watch him now. Lomax is trying to go deep. He couldn't find anyone, so he throws it off out here to the right. Now watch Anderson. He's not just going to run out of bounds. See him just before he gets it? He lowered that left shoulder and said, give me one good shot before I go out.
A gain of 19. Lomax back quickly. Look out. He does get it away to Green, and what a catch by Roy Green. Spectacular catch by Roy Green, who's hurt a little bit. He might be shaken a bit.
Yeah, but what a throw by Neil Lomax on that play. He was... As you said, look out, he got hit just as he threw that one to Roy Green.
Green is down.
Watch Roy Green. He's the slot man, the second guy in there. Comes up, runs a quick in. Now he's wide open there, catches the ball. I think what happened to him, I think he just fell on the ball and probably had the wind knocked out of him. But watch Lomax. Watch, just as he steps up, he sees Green. He throws that ball, and look at the jolt that he takes by Charles Mann from behind. tell you, that'll clear the sinuses.
The quarterbacks do earn the money. Green, I think, is okay. I think what happened is he just landed on the ball and the wind is knocked out of him. I think he's all right.
And I'm sure if he's all right that they want to get him well quickly and get him right back in on the next play. Not this play, but the next one.
That's a timeout charge to St. Louis, by the way.
In fact, Roy Green is over in the Cardinal huddle on the sideline. And with the timeout, he could go back in, but I don't think he's going to on this play.
If there is an injury after the two-minute warning, it's a charge timeout. That's what happened to the Cardinals right there. Timeouts are important, but not as important as Roy Green.
Right, and when you're on the 30-yard line with a minute 33 seconds, that's plenty of time.
They go with two tight ends and one setback. It's Anderson as Lomax comes out of the pocket and throws. He got Pat Tilley for a first down at about the 21.
You always wonder at the end of the game or the end of the half why it's so easy, and everyone says, well, why don't they play it like this all the time? Why haven't they been doing it? I think this is Pat Tilley's first catch. Well, the defense is playing a different type of defense. That was Tilley's second catch.
Right.
But they're playing a different type of defense because they're trying to use the clock, and these things do work, but maybe the Redskins are getting a little too soft.
Roy Green is back, by the way, in the slot. Tilley is wide to the left. Pittman is wide to the right. Green, some funny motion. Lomax going in that direction. He may have him. No, it's picked off by Darryl Green. Darryl Green made a great recovery. Dexter Manley put the heat on Lomax.
Green starts in motion. He's going to be out there in the left. Pretty good pass protection. They pick everything off. Now, right at the end, Manley was right there by Lomax. Maybe that took a little off it and let Darryl Green get in front of Roy Green for the interception. Big play for the Redskins. That has to hurt those Cardinals.
Manley was right in Lomax's face, and as you said, he couldn't get much on the throw.
The National Football League is something more than competition, more than the emotions of victory or defeat. There's also a family of professionals and a sense of commitment, not only to the game, but to the communities and to all the people that are part of that bigger family. This year and for more than a decade, NFL Charities has provided funds to the dozens of underfunded colleges serving minority students, to the dedicated volunteer groups fighting against drug and alcohol abuse, to disadvantaged older persons, including some former NFL players who are now in dire need, and to the many organizations that contribute to the goodness of our country and the hopes of its citizens. NFL Charities is there, making a difference in the lives of people. This message furnished by the National Football League.
Watch the interception again. Here's Roy Green. He's going to start here, go in motion, stop, come back. Then he's going to come up, run and out, and then an up. But Darryl Green right here stays with him all the way and gets the interception. Watch Roy Green and his quickness matched by Darryl Green and his quickness. See the motion to stop? Now he's going to come back here. Darryl Green staying with him all the way. Look, the out move, now the up move. He looks like he has him. Green is running stride for stride. The ball's thrown just a little short, because Manley was there, and Darryl Green gets the interception.
And the Redskins move it back to the 20, and that's where they take over with a minute 20 left to play in the first half. Rickon rolls left for about six. E.J. Jr. made the stop.
Rickon's made the run. Grimm and Jacoby make the hole over there. There's Russ Grimm. He's firing out on Galloway. Jacoby's firing out on Greer. Look at Jacoby take Greer, stop him, turn him to the outside, and then here comes Riggo.
Second and four. Riggins again. Bangs out about a foot or two short of a first down before he's stopped by E.J. Jr. 30 5 seconds left to play in the first half, and the Cardinals take a timeout. I beg your pardon. It was not a timeout signal. It was a first down signal. Neil Lomax. Clock still runs. The word on Stump Mitchell is he has a deep thigh bruise and will not return. Heisman going to work. It's Calvin Muhammad covered by Wayne Smith. Coming up at the half in just a few seconds. Scores and highlights with Brent Nerve and John Jefferson, the forgotten man. Clock is stopped with 9 seconds left to play.
I'll tell you, Calvin Muhammad came to this team at the right time. You know, they had, other than Art Monk, they had really had injuries all year to their receivers, and they were able to pick up Muhammad in a trade. And now Charlie Brown is kind of back and in and out, but he hasn't played all day.
Theismann is just going to run out the clock. That'll be the end of the first half. That'll be the last play. The Redskins leave seemingly in command. As they head for the halftime conference, Redskins are on top of the Cardinals by the score of 23-7.
Give her the ultimate, a quality diamond of a carat or more. A point in every workday when you want a great tasting cup of coffee. That's why you need the new Mr. Coffee. Because only Mr. Coffee has Ultronic Brewing, a space-age system that brews the most perfect cup of coffee on this planet or any other.
True spirit of Christmas on Kodacolor VR Films. Kodak's sharpest, most dazzling color print films ever.
Dear Joe, I sent this gift because you're my very best friend, love. Santa Claus.
There's holiday excitement ahead on CBS Sports. Christmas Day, the Blue-Gray All-Star Football Classic. Then the NBA on CBS returns with the Philadelphia 76ers taking on the Detroit Pistons. December 29th and 30th, the NFC Divisional Playoffs. New Year's Eve, Purdue and Virginia clash in the Peach Bowl. New Year's Day, Heisman winner Doug Flutie leads Boston College against Houston in the Cotton Bowl. All here on CBS Sports.
Welcome back to New York, Irv. Let's remind everybody that at the conclusion of this game, of course, we will have our post-game show today. We will update what is happening as far as the playoffs are concerned. A lot of things are still unfolding. And also, we're going to have a special look at all those mighty records that have been broken today. Now, speaking of scores and getting you up to date, it's the scoreboard right now with the Chicago Bears leading Detroit 14-6. They are at the half. Greg Landry, of course. Eric Hipple is not quarterbacking the Lions, folks, but he's up there helping out in the broadcast booth. And here came Landry, looking for an open receiver for Chicago, chucked it toward Jay Saldy, and William Graham picked him off, and Mike Ditka says, wait a minute, that's not what I had in mind for Landry. So finally, they gave it to Calvin Thomas out of the eye. He banged on in for his first touchdown, had him ahead, and wouldn't you know it, Landry came right back down to Irv and tossed another interception. Well, he wasn't finished, you know. He got the Bears down to the one. He said, I won't throw this one. I'll just keep it and run on into the end zone. And, of course, Chicago's lost a couple of quarterbacks to injuries, and they have to use Landry in that way.
Wait, you think Landry's so accustomed to seeing those blue jerseys that he still wants to throw?
Probably wants to really aim it in their direction. Now, the New York Jets, they're having a lot of difficulty down in Tampa. John McKay's last game as a head coach, 17-7. The Bucs leading the Jets in that one. New England shutting out Indianapolis, and the offensive line coach Hal Hunter is coaching the Colts in that one. But CBS Sports has learned that Buddy Ryan, the defensive coordinator of the Chicago Bears, is a leading candidate to become the head coach of Indianapolis next season. Green Bay and Minnesota, and the Packers are dominating. Lynn Dickey, he threw a couple of touchdown passes, ran in for a third, and it is 31-0. They are in the third quarter. The Vikings may be quitting on head coach Les Stickle. At least that's what it appears as you watch one of the television monitors here this afternoon. Cincinnati and Buffalo, it is 28-7. The Bengals with a chance to go to the playoffs, but of course the Steelers would have to lose later today to the Raiders in order for that to be accomplished. Now Cleveland and Houston, that is 10-7. The Browns lead the Oilers. A mild upset that one would be. They're in the third quarter of that game. And of course the main one we watch unfolding from RFK Stadium, the Washington Redskins with an enormously important pass from Joe Theismann to Calvin Muhammad, and that regained the initiative for him, Irv, after the Cardinals had scored. But I'll tell you, Art Monk's had a great season.
Well, a great season, and here's touchdown pass number one on this ball game, and of course he's going to break all kinds of receiving records, and Jim Hanifin knows he's going to be in for a long day today.
And Irv, Joe came right back to Monk.
Well, again, he's the most sure-handed receiver in football. This time it's a short pass in the end zone for touchdown pass number two.
Irv, what happened to the receiver here?
You know, it's one of these plays where the receiver gave up on the pass pattern. You see Muhammad stop. Wayne Smith picked the ball off and rambled down to the one-yard line for the Cardinals.
Then Neil Lomax took it in, Irv, and suddenly the Cardinals were back in. The Redskins had missed an extra point, so they were only down by six. I think this was the biggest play of the half.
Unbelievable. The Redskins had to come back right away, and Theismann went to Calvin Muhammad, who has great speed. In a foot race with him, you're not going to win many races.
Then they got a little penalty and put the ball down on the five, and here came the diesel. Number 44, John Riggins, and what a difference he makes. Boy, he helped set up that pass for Joe Theismann, doesn't he? Now, we mentioned Buddy Ryan as a possibility for head coach in Indianapolis. Well, CBS Sports also expects former Brown coach Sam Ratigliano to be named the new head coach of the Buffalo Bills next week. We contacted Sam yesterday in Cleveland to get his reaction.
I've been in touch with a number of people, and, you know, Ralph Wilson called Art Modell to have permission to talk to me, and I've had an opportunity to talk to Ralph Wilson, and frankly, you know, he feels basically the same way as I do. I think the thing that he needs to do right now is to deal with the situation at Buffalo, and then, you know, when there is a vacancy, I am sure that I will be among many other candidates for the job.
Now, Ratigliano is very close to Boston College coach Jack Bicknell. In fact, he helped Jack get the job at Boston College, and that enhances the prospect that quarterback Doug Flutie may be headed for the Bills. The Buffalo management already has expressed interest in making Flutie their number one pick, and if they lose today to Cincinnati, the Bills will have first crack at him. Irv Cross is going to tell us about a wide receiver up in Green Bay who may be traded at the end of this season. We'll have that story when we continue after these messages from your local stations.
Tuesday, Alex is an advertising executive who gets the boot.
Nobody fires a Harvard graduate.
And they turn the tables to save the family.
We're gonna make you me and get you a job.
So with a phony name and resume, his portfolio, and lots of flashy makeup, she picks up where he left off.
Right.
Now, can she survive being him?
Finley thinks I'm a genius.
And can he survive being her?
Mr. Housewife.
Wayne Rogers and Karen Valentine star in He's Fired, She's Hired, Tuesday.
Oh, it's a classic.
This is CBS.
At AMCO, we care as much about people as we do transmissions.
It's this.
That's why you get AA service at AA MCO.
Now, there's a beer with a taste that'll turn you around. New Icy Golden Lager, brewed a little at a time, using the finest two-row barley and imported Bavarian hops. Icy Golden Lager. Kreuzen, slowly, the old world way, to bring out a rich, smooth, golden taste. Next time, make it golden. New Icy Golden Lager, for a golden taste above the rest, a taste that'll turn you around.
For over 30 years now, when we've reached out to help the kids at Children's Hospital, you've been there.
And we know we can count on you again this holiday season, especially Sunday night, December 16th, the night of the annual Children's Hospital Telethon on TV2.
We'll be broadcasting live from Westmoreland and Century 3 Malls, the Hilton Hotel, our Chile Traffic Circle, and from the halls of Children's Hospital.
We hope your family will join with our KDKA family for the Children's Hospital Telethon, Sunday, December 16th at 8 on TV2.
You know, I always feel good about making my family's contribution to Christmas sales. They helped Jennifer with her asthma and did a lot for my dad's emphysema, and even helped Dawn to quit smoking. Sure, there are a lot of demands on our budget right now, but Christmas sales always gets a contribution because they do so much for the people you really care about.
Crowning Glory, Monday on Evening Magazine.
Except for the 10 teams headed for the playoffs, a lot of the other squads are looking ahead now to the draft and trades. And one of the forgotten men in the league who's about to become available is wide receiver John Jefferson. Now, when he first burst upon the scene 7 years ago out of Arizona State, he was one of the most feared pass-receiving threats in the game. But they don't throw many passes his way these days up in Green Bay, and John Jefferson has become this year's version of the lonesome end. Irv?
At wide receiver from Arizona State, number 83... John Jefferson.
To football fans, he is known simply as JJ. With his acrobatic catches and graceful moves, John Jefferson helps set the standard by which other receivers are measured. His smile lit up the stadium, but then it was time for him to leave San Diego and move on.
In 1981, J.J. left sunny San Diego and became a Packer millionaire. He joined with James Lofton, and opponents would wince at the idea of covering two of the league's best receivers together on one team. J.J. helped the Packers to the playoffs a year later, and he felt at ease here at frozen Lambeau Field.
Welcome to Green Bay, Wisconsin. Home of the Green Bay Packers, the winter wonderland of the USA.
But the seasons in Green Bay began to create a big chill. And the pass catcher with a sunny disposition suddenly felt frozen out.
It's probably a very slim chance, you know, that I will return because my contract, you know, pretty much up and I have some leverage. Everybody's been nice to me. That hasn't anything to do with it. I just don't feel the way I've been feeling, you know, in the past years, and that's bad. I only caught 26 passes this year. Pretty much of a disaster, statistically speaking. And being a Z receiver, I really haven't got the first call. I'm always the second or third, you know, option. I was averaging something like 3, maybe 4 attempts a game. It's not a whole lot you can do with that many attempts. I mean, just balls thrown in your area, period. I can't make up any excuses, and I won't make any excuses. I don't think I've been playing where I'm capable, probably because of those reasons.
John feels that James Lofton here is strong competition for him. The ego part of it is probably a big part of it. I don't doubt that for 1 minute.
I don't think it's a matter of money or not liking the team or not liking the players. I just think he wants to move on where he can better himself as a player and be the main target.
JJ doesn't mind sharing the glory, but he's not about to give up top billing. If it means moving on yet again, he'll do whatever it takes.
I proved what I wanted to prove a long time ago, and I'd like to probably make it to a Super Bowl before my career is up, and I would feel real good about myself. And I was pretty excited being here, and the last couple of years have been up and down, and there may be better things out there.
Where would he like to go, Irv?
He said he wants to go to a big city, warm weather climate, and a team that has a shot at winning the Super Bowl. Who wouldn't, right?
Miami Dolphins are full of receivers.
How about the Raiders?
All right. I'll send you back down to the stadium and the game you're enjoying on CBS.
And if you're a Redskin fan, you're enjoying this one because the Redskins lead 23-7 at the half. Pat Summerall here with John Madden again. John, what do you think the Cardinals really realistically have to do to get back into this thing?
Well, you know, the one thing, the Redskins are playing them in a soft defense, and Lomax really hasn't had much open down the field, so he's had to dump off a lot. I think one thing he has to do is tighten the Redskin defense up, and the way to do that is to be able to run. In the first half, the Cardinals have only rushed for 9 yards, and I don't think they have to run a lot, but I think they have to have some success with the run to tighten up that Redskin defense.
Let's go back and sort of review what happened in the first half and look at some of the crucial things. Here's Art Monk's first touchdown of the first half. He's had two. Watch his work here on Lionel Washington. Up, gets away from him, starts to the post, goes to the corner. Great throw by Theismann, and a great effort by Art Monk, who is closing in on the all-time number of catches in a season in the NFL, held by Charlie Hennigan. Look at the hit that Theismann took, though, on that touchdown pass, just to give you a bit of evidence about how tough he is. Ramsey Dardar really put a whack on Joe Theismann. He never saw the completion, believe me. Later, John Madden will show you some other work.
Well, here's the big interception, and we're going to see Muhammad come in here and run kind of a confused slant. Wayne Smith jumps in front and gets the interception for the Cardinals. He got it down to about the 1 yard line, and they scored on the next play. But you see, Muhammad starts in. He starts to come under control. Theismann leads him in. Smith catches the ball and takes it down to the goal line. That was one big play for the Cardinals in the first half. And of course, here's the thing that really hurt him was a blocked punt, the first of Bert Song's career. We see Rich Marty, he fakes to the outside, comes to the inside, blocks the punt right here. Now, this was a big play for the Redskins because they got this right after they had scored. They had the momentum. This got big momentum back for him right away.
So we head into the second half at sold out Robert F. Kennedy Stadium with the Redskins leading 23-7.
You know, one of the best things about being an ex-big leaguer is getting freebies to the game. Call the front office, bingo. And once these fans recognize me, I probably won't even have to pay for my light beer from Miller.
Down it, Brock!
I love them. These fans know I drink light because it's less filling and it tastes great. Good seats, huh?
You're in the wrong shape, buddy. Come on.
Oh! I must be in the front row.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Good seats, eh, buddy? He missed the tag!
The personal computer game is heating up.
May I?
Go ahead. The AT&T personal computer is faster, 2 to 3 times faster than the IBM PC. It has a higher resolution screen, too, for better graphics, and runs thousands of business programs. In fact, it's more computer for the money to put your business ahead of the game.
Your move.
The AT&T personal computer. For the dealer nearest you, call 1-800-247-1212.
This is Walter. For 12 years, Walter's been in charge of security around here, but today, he's gonna get some help. You see, Allstate's gonna save me some money on my homeowner's insurance with a Shape Up and Save discount. And all I've gotta do is make things a little safer with a deadbolt lock, fire extinguisher, smoke alarm, so I save some money. And Walter can relax.
Shape Up and Save.
Keep an eye on the silver, will you, guy?
You're in good hands with Allstate.
Ready to go with the second half. Washington 23, St. Louis 7. Jeff Hayes kicks it off. Danny Pittman at the 7. With room. Pittman, good return. Knocked out of bounds about the 39-yard line. Halftime statistics. Neither team has been able to run very much. Redskins only have 47 yards. The Cardinals just have 9.
That's the thing that I think they have to do. And again, as I said, I don't think they're going to beat the Redskins or even get close to them just running. But I think they have to run enough to tighten them up because they aren't able to get open in those mid-range and deep pass patterns.
Neil Lomax will operate the Cardinal offense from his own 38-yard line. Going right to work, or trying to, and there's the short pass for Roy Green. Roy Green lunges up close to a first. I'm sorry, it's John Good.
That was the thing. I think he was trying to go deep to Roy Green. Roy Green was on the same side, and he was running a quarter pattern. He was watching Roy Green, and then he had to come back short and dump off to John Good. Watch Roy Green come off the ball here. He takes an inside move, back up the field. He's doubled there, back to the corner. Lomax was looking there early, didn't have time, so he had to throw it to Good shorter.
John Good, with that last lunge, came close to first down yardage. They bring the sticks all the way across the field to measure. Good was knocked out of bounds right in front of the Cardinal bench. 23-7 Redskins over St. Louis. First down. Lomax paying a quick visit over to the Cardinal bench. 13 out of 19 he is for 164 yards, the one interception. That by Darryl Green in the Redskin end zone. Jim Hannifin looking on. He and Joe Gibbs, longtime good friends, coached together, communicated with each other.
Well, they had coached together both with the St. Louis Cardinals and later the San Diego Chargers.
Both times under Don Coryell. Here's Lomax. He gets it outside to Anderson. Earl Farrell, sorry, again.
I think there's really something going on down there in that Redskin defense that is stopping Lomax from throwing deep, because he's having to do this too much to just be an accident. I mean, he's looking deep, can't find anything deep. It seems like the whole game, he's always having to dump off to a shorter man.
Well, you remember what Lomax said to us last night. He said, they always give us something, one thing that we've never seen before. And it just takes a while to figure it out. So far, I don't think they have. Lomax rolls right, puts a jump shot in the direction of Anderson, who breaks a tackle with a good stiff arm. He put the stiff arm on Rich Mallott, and the flag is down.
The Cardinals have only gained 9 yards rushing, but they're sure getting a lot of production out of Otis Anderson on these little dump passes. They're not getting any production out of a holding call, though, that'll put them back 10 yards from the original line of scrimmage.
Jim Hannifin upset.
To the hands, number 80, offense, second down.
But it was Doug Marsh there, number 80, against Mel Kaufman. You see it right there on the right-hand side of the screen. You see him coming in there, and he's trying to block, and he's doing one of those illegal block from behind. That's what happens when that guy moves on you, and you're committed to go after him. He really didn't do much. It was too bad, though.
St. Louis has been penalized 5 times. The play will stand, so it'll make it 2nd and 1 at the Redskin 41. Here's Lomax on a rollout. Gets away from Mallott. He gets the first down back and gets out of bounds.
Going to be a bootleg, but it wasn't going to be a bootleg run. It was supposed to be a pass. Again, Roy Green down here in the bottom. You see him fake to Otis Anderson, come out here on a waggle. He's looking for Green, can't find him, decides to run, turns the ball upfield. He's not going to take one of those hook slides deal. He's going to get as much as he can until he runs into a guy in a yellow deal. Look at him. He grabbed that guy, wrapped his arms around him, tackle him, hit anything that's moving.
Lomax got 13 yards on that run, more than the Cardinals got rushing in the first half. Lomax back to throw, fires, Green. At the 20, that'll be enough for another first down.
I think that's the type of pattern that they're going to have to start getting. You know, they don't have the time for the deep pattern, but this is stuff around 10 or 12 yards where you push the defense up. Watch Roy Green as the outside receiver. He comes up. Make him think he's going to go deep. Now just stop. Find a hole between the defenders and pick up that first down.
Remember, this is what the Giants did to the Cardinals earlier in the year. They just put everybody deep and said, you're not going to beat us with a deep throw.
As Jim Hannifin said last night, even if they do, we're still going to try and get deep.
Lomax back to throw again. He gets it outside to John Good. And Good is taken down on a solid hit by Curtis Jordan.
Yeah, that didn't get much, but that's the same type of pattern, you know, that Otis Anderson has been catching and John Good catches. It's that second guy. It's that guy underneath, that short guy. You look deep, if there's nothing open, you hit him.
pickup of just three. So it's second and seven from the 17 with just over 12 and a half minutes left to play, third quarter. Earl Farrell and Otis Anderson are the two running backs for the Cardinals. Romax quick. Intended for Green, who slipped down, covered by Darryl Green. Darryl Green and Roy Green. That's been a heck of a battle all day long.
I'll tell you, and I think that Neil Lomax threw that one a little too quick, but I think you have to let the guy work a little more than that. As Green was coming out of his move, he slipped. I guess Lomax just saw that and just had to throw it out of bounds.
Well, he's been under so much pressure from the Redskin rush. He has to be very much aware of that. Roy Green and Danny Pittman are split wide to the left. Tilly is out to the right. Here comes the pressure. Lomax gets out of most of it. He can't get out of all of it. He's down inside the 15 to about the 14, and Rich Mullott keeps him down.
This is going to be very close to a first down, and it's going to be an interesting decision, although the Cardinals have already made the decision. They're going to go for the field goal.
The Redskins had three players hurt. That's Monty Coleman right there. There were three of them who were applying the pressure to Lomax, and three of them who stayed down. One was Manley, one was Coleman, and he's still down. Cardinals have decided on field goal. It's 23-7.
Nothing works like a Chevy truck. Nothing works like a Chevy truck. Tough on the job, easy on the buck. Nothing works like a Chevy truck.
Rugged, massive girder beam front suspension. Tough double wall construction in critical areas, and new Vortec V6 power. A hard day's work goes easier when you have a truck with the built-in tough of a Chevy.
Nothing works like a Chevy truck. Nothing works like a Chevy truck.
At a recent wine tasting near Rome, some restaurateurs discovered a special American wine.
Elegant.
They thought it excellent.
Bueno.
And they tried to guess its price. Most guessed between $7 and $10. Except for one.
Not even $3.
Who was the judge who knew the wine did not cost $7 to $10? Francesco Giambelli, who had served the wine at his famous restaurant in New York, Gallo Chablis Blanc. From Ernest and Giulio Gallo, all the best.
On that last play, watch Roy Green here, the move that he puts on Darryl Green. He is wide open. But Neil Lomax gets pressure, but watch Green there. He goes inside. Look at him. He's wide open right there. That would have been a touchdown. But see, now here's why he couldn't do it. Watch Lomax. He knows that Green's there. You see, he gets that pressure up the middle. Now he can't see him. Now he has to go, and it ends up in a run. But had he had protection in that middle, that would have been a Cardinal touchdown. Roy Green was wide open.
Oh, Donahue is 21 out of 32 for the year. Benny Perrin holding just outside the 20-yard line. They're calling it a 30-yard attempt. Kick is up and good. And the Cardinals pull back a little bit closer. It's 23-10 now with 11:43 left to play in the third quarter. The Redskins missed an extra point. That could, as we said before, many, many times, turn out to be very important. Checking the other score. Cincinnati had to win. Looks like they will. Still depends on what the Steelers do against the Raiders. Bears 14-6 over Detroit. Green Bay 31-7 over Minnesota. And the Buccaneers 20-7 over the Jets. 13-3 New England over Indianapolis. And Cleveland and Houston tied at 10 apiece, third quarter. Here it's 23-10. Redskins lead the Cardinals for all the marbles in the NFC East. O'Donohue set to kick off. Mike Nelms back deep for the Redskins. Off the side of his foot to Keith Griffin, who fields it right on the sideline, stays in bounds. Is knocked out of bounds at about the 27. $11.30 35 left to play in the third quarter. The Cardinals got a 30-yard field goal by Neil O'Donoghue. Eight plays, they went 49 yards. They kept the ball 3 minutes, 17 seconds. There's Roy Green over on the sideline.
He's probably telling Neil Womack there about that play and about how wide open he was. Womack said, I know, I couldn't see. We'll get it next time.
We hope. The give is to Riggins. Riggins, side to 30, about the 31 or 2. David Galloway behind Grimm and Jacoby.
That's what he does. And as E.J. Jr. was saying last night, he said, you know, this crowd goes wild when Riggins gains 4 or 5 yards. And he said, it's really not that bad. He said, but you start to think that it's bad. See, that was Donnelly that just picked off E.J. Jr. there so that he couldn't get to Riggins. But that is true. He goes 4 yards and they get a big cheer.
That time he got 5. Or 4. Here he goes again. Flag is down, a penalty marker down. David Galloway and Benny Perrin tripped up Riggins. Against the Cardinals. Tripping.
That's one that you don't see very often. Sometimes if a guy gets faked or fooled and he can't get his hands or arms on you, he'll just stick out a foot.
Tripping, number 62, defense, automatic first down.
There's Ramsey Gardner. He said, what in the heck was that one? Let's just see if we can watch the whole thing and see Dardar there. He's a left tackle. He's right here. And let's just watch and see how he gets a trip in there. See, he starts to the outside. Now as Riggins kicks back in, look, he just kicks his right foot up. Gives Riggins a kick. That is a trip or a kick. Maybe it's a kick.
More kicking than tripping. Here is Theismann looking outside. To Don Warren, taken out of bounds by Lionel Washington after another gain of about 4.
You know, we were talking to Jim Hannifin last night. He said, you know, of all the guys in the Redskin team, they get a lot of talk, 2 Super Bowls and all, he said, but probably their most underrated player is Donnie Warren. He said, over the years, he said, his blocking, catching a little pass here and there, he said, he's hurt us as much as a lot of those other guys have.
That son of a gun can block, he said.
Yeah, and he said he's really, you know, has done a good job on Thomas Howard over the years.
2nd and 7 for the Redskins at their own 49. They lead by 13 points. Didier on the move. Theismann back to throw. Has time. Underthrows Didier. He is being covered by Charlie Baker. That'll make it 3rd and long. And here comes Joe Washington. Comes Riggins. Joe Washington has been up and down and unable to practice. Bad knees. He's had a bunch of knee operations. Hasn't been able to practice. He's not as effective, quite frankly, as he has been over the years. He just had a tough time.
You know, Joe Gibbs always calls him the little guy. You know, he said, well, the little guy's thing. The little guy hasn't played. The little guy this and that. That was fine last year, and then this year he got Keith Griffin, and he calls him the little guy. So he says, the little guy this and that. You don't know who he's talking about, Joe Washington or Keith Griffin.
This is a Redskin timeout, so that'll leave him with 2 in the second half.
Looks like you're into winning.
You bet.
Then today, Chevrolet has a car for you, Cavalier.
Come on in, and you'll know, turn it.
Liters of electronically fuel-injected power, front drive agility, and optional sports suspension. Cavalier. Grab one.
If this is today's Chevrolet, it's a winner.
Drive today, Chevy. Live today, Chevy.
Live it.
Chevy.
There's no better way to end a perfect day than to head for the best beer you can find. At Miller High Life, we begin with nature's finest ingredients. Then we brew our beer so it contains no additives, no preservatives. So nothing comes between you and the taste of just pure beer.
Welcome to Miller Time.
23-10. The Redskins lead the Cardinals. Santa Claus was here at halftime, and he stayed around.
Santa looks like an old coach.
They have a linebacker out covering Didier, looks like man-to-man. Theismann. Drop the snap.
Well, you don't see that happen often. You know, we talked about how their all-pro center, Jeff Bostic, has been out, but Rick Donnelly has really been doing a good job. It looked like someone left early, like all the other guys left early, and maybe other than a bad snap, that could have been a late snap.
Did look like the rest of the linemen thought the count was earlier.
Yep, they all weren't in sync on that one.
Jeff Hayes back to punt. Danny Pittman back deep for the Cardinals. It's a high hanger. Pittman lets it go. And it goes into the end zone. They'll bring it back to the 20. Very nearly an excellent punt by Hayes. It was a good punt. It just didn't quite work out the way he'd like it to. In the Sun Bowl next Saturday. Three games coming your way. Bowl games coming your way on CBS. Maryland and Tennessee. Two outstanding passing teams in the Sun Bowl. December the 31st, Purdue and Virginia will go at it in the Peach Bowl. Then on New Year's Day, the Heisman Trophy winner Doug Flutie will play his final collegiate game for Boston College against the Southwest Conference champions Houston. That'll be in the Cotton Bowl, of course. Right here on CBS.
Personal foul
roughness against the Cardinals.
Number 31 on the receiving team. First down on the 10-yard line.
So the Cardinals have their work cut out for them. First and 10 from the 10 with 9:55 left to play third quarter.
There's Big Dave Butts. Look at that. They got the arm, the helmet's all bashed up. Jersey's saying, come on, let's go. Come on, give us some work here in the pit. Run at us. I play the run. You guys don't run. Run in here. See what you got. What they say down there.
Crowd coming alive as Lomax goes back to throw. If he has time, he does get it out to Anderson again. Anderson bangs out close to a first down. Mel Kaufman over to make the hit that stopped him. Anderson's caught seven passes today for 78 yards. That's been their most effective play.
We were just talking about Dave Butts, and on that play, he took his guy right here. Just watch this matchup here. Here, as he just takes his guy and drives him right back here to Lomax. Watch Dave Butts. He's going against Joe Bostic there. Watch him. He just takes him. He's so doggone strong. Bostic's trying to hold him, do anything. He's like he's on skates. And Butts gets right in Lomax's face. Look at him. Now that's fighting in the pits. I mean, those are big guys going against each other, grabbing, doing stuff, holding, headbutting, tackling, down, dirt, mud.
First and 10 from the 21. They did get the first down. Lomax looks over the Redskin defense. Gets it outside again to Anderson. Not much doing this time as they punish him. Vernon Dean with inside help. Dean was the first man to hit him. The other was Neil Olkowitz.
It's one thing about these Redskin corners, both Darryl Green and Vernon Dean, that they're good tacklers. A lot of corners are good cover guys, and they don't get involved much in the run. But in the Redskin scheme of things, they use their corners as support guys, and they're both very good tacklers. That was a nice time. You know, the form of the arms wrap, head up, you know, butt down, knees bent, toes straight ahead.
A gain of four, second and six from the 25. Cardinals have just about given up trying to run. Green, I don't think they'll catch it. Touchdown, Cardinals, 75 yards. He finally burned them. Monty Coleman and Curtis Jordan were chasing, but it's like the dogs never catch the rabbit.
Not that rabbit right there. You know, we had seen him talking on the sidelines, Neil Lomax and Roy Green, and you knew they were talking about something. And when those guys talk, it's always about finding something deep. But I'll tell you, what made this was a good pass protection. Lomax looked right, he looks left. He had time to get Green deep in the middle, and then he found him, and then, of course, it's all over.
Plenty of time left in this contest. Lomax will try the extra point with Benny Perrin holding. Red
Redskins 23, the Cardinals 16. O'Donohue. Sorry, I said Lomax, didn't I? The extra point is good for Neil O'Donohue. Well now, that makes things a lot more interesting at RFK. And the crowd is not quite so vocal. 23-17.
With all their space-age technology, most microwave ovens still cook too many things unevenly. Undercooked here, overcooked there. A problem you won't have with the Sharp Carousel 2 convection microwave, thanks to Sharp's turntable design that cooks food evenly at every turn. After all, what's the point of owning a microwave if it can't even do the little things right? Sharp microwaves from Sharp Minds come Sharp products.
This is today's Chevrolet, and this is today's Chevrolet. This Chevrolet is specially modified for the International Race of Champions. This is a new Camaro IROC Z28 built for you. Chevrolet encourages the use of selected parts and components by race teams, and that helped us build this Chevrolet. World champions drive this Camaro, but the Camaro IROC Z28 makes you feel like a champion.
Drive today, Chevy. Live today, Chevy. Chevy.
Watch that player, Roy Green, again. Here he is. Here's Darryl Green covering. Roy Green starts up, gets underneath, comes up, and then back in here. Lomax back here has plenty of time, and he finds Green for the big reception and the touchdown. Watch him come off the ball outside, fakes out, comes back in, runs underneath here, makes an adjustment right there up the field. Now he's behind the whole defense. And when he gets the ball, they're not going to catch him. That's all over. You can give him a touchdown there at the 30-yard line. I tell you, the thing that made that was a pass protection.
Look at Jim Hannifin's reaction.
Head coaches all like touchdowns.
He almost jumped. I guess that would be legal.
He's saying they missed an extra point earlier. We're back in this thing.
O'Donohue kicks it off. Nelms will handle it at the Redskin 10. Nelms had an opening for a moment. Is cut down by Willard Harrell, I think. Led the special teams. Green now 6 catches for 150 yards on the day. The drive, if you can call it that, was 3 plays. And they went 90 yards. 75 yards on the pass from Lomax to Roy Green. It's 23-7 with 8:06 left to play. The Cardinals won the first meeting between these two, 26-20. 24, I beg your pardon, but a last-second field goal by O'Donohue. Riggins left side.
Look at that pile up there. Riggins draws a crowd when he goes there. Everyone, guys are in front of him blocking, and all those other guys all come and jump on. He causes big piles when he carries the ball. There's only one back in the backfield. Everyone's keying him. If you're going to run, he's the only guy you can hand it to. So he starts to let everyone just runs there and jumps on him.
He got his 4 yards. So make it 2nd and 6 at 31. Seisman doesn't like what he sees and has to call another timeout. They only have one left. Comes over to talk things over with Joe Gibbs. Strange how things change. That one play, the pass to Green, has changed the whole complexion of this game.
This is today's Chevrolet.
Come on in, take the wheel, start it up, get the feel of the road that rolls on. Straight ahead, on your own, the light turns green and you're going on the road that rolls on.
The road rolls on. You're today Chevy, be today Chevy, drive today Chevy, live today Chevy.
Live it.
Chevy.
It's a Radio Shack Merry Christmas.
The TRS-80 Color Computer 2 is a great family gift. On sale only $99.95 with these instant loading program packs. It's a game arcade, a home manager, an educational center. And you can learn to program. It's expandable with a typewriter quality keyboard.
Now this is a family gift I can really afford.
The sale price TRS-80 Color Computer 2, $99.95, only at Radio Shack.
A little bit misty, still very hazy in the nation's capital. Barely can see the Capitol building itself as you look back from RFK Stadium. Our camera up on top of the stadium. Second down and six. The Redskins have it at their own 31, 7:21. Left to play. Riggins is out and Joe Washington is in. That's left to play in the third quarter. Blitzing. This is Art Monk. Wayne Smith, the tackler. That ties the all-time record held by Charlie Hennigan of 101 receptions in a season. There's the list again. Art Monk has just tied the record set back in 1964 by Charlie Hennigan.
You know, and the interesting thing is no one in the Redskin huddle congratulated him. They may not know it, but I'm sure they're all thinking we have a lot more important work to do here now. We'll do that after.
Leisman to Riggins. Riggins over the left side. Again, they get what they want on first down. He got about five. The average yards on first down, I didn't think it'd be that high, did you?
Well, the 7.8, that could have, you know, come on a big pass play. You know, which it did. The Redskins are averaging 6.6. The St. Louis Cardinals, 7.8. But that's what you want to do, especially the Redskins. You know, if they can get that type of football, then they can keep Riggins in the game. Then they can either give him the ball or play fake to him. The Cardinals are just about passing on every down now.
Second and six from the 46. Cardinals blitz. Theismann does get it away, but just barely. Bubba Baker's walking away from that last scramble, and now he goes down on the ground. Says he's okay.
It looked like he got something right on the hip or the stomach there. He was right there on Joe Theismann. That's John Riggins blocking him there. See, Riggins blocking him, and then he looks like his own man hit him right there. The three of them got to Theismann about the same time. He was giving Theismann's helmet a little rough job there, and then he's still bent over.
Stafford Mays that hit him.
Yeah, he was so happy that he got back there, and then he gets whacked by two of his own guys.
The Pug of Bubba's hanging in there. Third and six. Joe Washington remains. Didier goes wide to the left. Take a blitz. Come out of it. Theismann has Monk, and Monk has the record. Monk barrels down inside the 20 to about the 15 before Benny Perrin stopped him.
Now that's the type of play you want to break the record on. A championship game, your team needs a drive. Down by six, that's when you want to do it. The fans know it. Joe Theismann is looking. Good pass protection there. Finds Monk, steps up. Monk's behind his defender. Takes one look at him, then decides to outrun him until he meets two others.
Now they're going to get him the ball.
It'll be interesting. interesting now, Pat, to see who that fires up. Does that fire up the Cardinals or does that fire up the Redskins?
The ball is at the 18 and they give it to Riggins. Riggins gets a couple and is hammered by E.J. Jr.
Riggins was trying to get in there behind Joe Jacoby, and E.J. Jr. sneaked in between Jacoby and Riggins. Watch 68 and 66 will pull, but watch Jacoby there. Riggins is trying to get in behind him, and then E.J. Jr. sneaks in behind Jacoby. How do you sneak in? Well, I guess a guy's that big, you can sneak.
That's about the only way you're going to get in.
Well, like Junior's like 240. If you're 240, you can sneak behind a 300-pounder.
Riggins only got a yard as they put Didier in motion again, and Theismann goes back to throw it. The 30-second clock had expired. I believe that's what they're going to say.
Delay of game, number seven.
Delay of game, number seven, offense, second down.
And that's the first Washington penalty of the day. Maybe it's a good thing the clock did expire, because Curtis Greer had gotten around Jacoby and was really taking aim at Theismann. Look at those signals.
Yeah, Don Breaux, he's the offensive backfield coach. He gets the play from Joe Gibbs. Joe Gibbs calls all the offensive plays, and Don Breaux signals them in to Joe Theismann.
Joe Washington has replaced Riggins. Second down and 14 at the Cardinal 22. Back to throw. Outside to Washington. E.J. Jr. out there with him at the 20-yard line. A gain, but not much. 2 yards.
E.J. Jr. is having some game. He's there on the run to help stop Riggins. He's out there covering guys. He was saying last night that he was surprised that he made the Pro Bowl, because he started out and played most of the year as an outside linebacker, then moved to the middle, which he's playing today. And he said he wasn't sure where they would put him up, as an outside or middle. The Cardinals put him up as a middle linebacker, and he got voted to the Pro Bowl.
It's third and 12 from the 20. Theismann will have to go to work throwing again. Cardinals are coming after it. It's for Monk in the corner. It's incomplete, and there are no penalty markers down. Lionel Washington was back there with Art Monk, Jim Hannifin, and Floyd Peters.
That was an interesting coverage, because they were able to blitz and at the same time have double coverage on Art Monk.
37 yards out will be Mark Mosley, with Theismann holding when he tries this field goal. He's one for one today, but he missed an extra point. He hammers it through. The Redskins extend their lead now to 9 points. 26 to 17 with 3:54 left to play third quarter.
Here's to good friends.
Terrific reunion.
Yeah. The last time we were here, we made history.
Tonight is kind of special.
I stole that ball. I made the pass.
I made the shot.
Make that shot again, we'll buy you a loan, Rob.
The beer will pour. Must say something more. Something.
Hey, what can I tell you? We still got it.
Tonight, never lost it.
Let it be low and brown.
Do you have anything in aviation?
The Army's most technical training.
Are there any openings in communications?
Is also the Army's most popular training.
I'd really like computers.
So it pays to have a reservation.
Electronics.
If you qualify, you can get a guaranteed reservation for the training you want up to 12 months in advance, even if you're still in high school.
Be all that you can be.
We'll see you after graduation.
You can do
it. Great.
In the Army.
Thank you. Congratulations.
That scene is taking place up in Moonaki, New Jersey. Casey Merrill, as the Giants, many of the members of the Giants watching this game and watching this broadcast. They are, of course, still alive and have playoff hopes.
Of course, they're all rooting for the Redskins. If the Cardinals win, that will eliminate the Giants today.
Jeff Hayes starts to kick it off. Line drive kickoff. to Willard Harrell. The one, he'll start from there. Willard Harrell gets it out to about the 30. Down he goes. 29-yard return. He's hit by Rich Maudie. Here is the situation again. If Washington wins, the Redskins are the champions of the NFC East. The wild card game will be the Rams against the Giants or Cowboys. If St. Louis wins, the Cardinals are the NFC East champions, and the wild card game will match Washington against either the Rams or the Cowboys. 26-17 Redskins. Again, Lomax back to throw. Dumps it off to Otis Anderson. He gets out to about the 35. A pickup of in the neighborhood of 6 yards. Neil Okolitz and Mel Kaufman on the stop.
You know, in the Cardinal game plan, this is really their version of the running game. On first down, what they're doing is they're going, they have the deep receivers down there. Then if they can't find them, they just dump off short, and that picks them up to 5 or 6 yards. So when you look at the stats and you say, gee, they couldn't run, well, that's true. But if you look at the stats on what they've done on first down, they've been successful.
Anderson has 9 catches for 89 yards. Go now with 3 wide receivers, Green and Pittman to the right. Handoff is to Anderson on the draw play, and O.J. gets the first down. Charles Mann tripped him up. Anderson's longest run of the day right there.
We were talking at halftime. That was the type of thing that I think the Cardinals have to do, is they have to be able, if the Redskin defense is going to play him loose, they have to be able to pop a run in there every now and then. They just did, and they got a first down.
10 for 14. That's Anderson's record on the ground. The line of scrimmage is the Redskin or the Cardinal 43. 2:20 left to play in the third quarter. Farrell was the man in motion. Reception to Doug Marsh, his first catch of the day. Stopped by Rich Mullott. A gain of 5.
I think they decided to work that offside. You know, they have on one side, they have Roy Green out there and Pat Tilley, and then they came back to this other side where they had to back in the tight end.
You see what they've done in the second half as far as their play selection is concerned. Threw it 11 times and ran with it 3 times. 5-yard pickup then, 2nd and 5 at the 48. Has completed 10 out of his last 11 throws. Marsh, the move man, stays in the block. Outside to Anderson again. And O.J. Anderson whirls down to the Redskin 31-yard line. 21-yard pickup and another first down.
You know, he picked up about 5 or 6 more yards by a good block by his tight end, John Good. We'll see it down there. They keep Doug Marsh, the other tight end, in. Now watch 84, Good there. You see, he's on the offside. Anderson catches it there. Good gets a little shield block right there in the right-hand part of the picture, and that let Anderson get about 8 more yards.
They are out quickly.
Look at Otis take off by 31.
Green moves out to the right side. Anderson, get at the line of scrimmage, no gain. Rich Mullott, Dave Butts, Dexter Manley, all there.
I'll tell you, when you have those big guys in the middle, like, you know, Dave Butts, Darrell Grant, Brooks and those guys, and Neil Okowitz, it is tough to run in the middle against the Redskin defense. The best way to attack them, really, is with the pass. Look at Dave Butts, that helmet. Now, that's been in a few football games.
Lomax is already headed for the sideline. That's the last play of the third quarter. And they'll change ends of the field. And indeed, that's the end of the third quarter. With the score, the Redskins 26 and the Cardinals 17. We now pause for a word from your local station.
UCLA battles Chris Mullin and fourth-ranked St. John's, plus college football, Maryland against Tennessee in the Sun Bowl next Saturday on CBS Sports.
This is CBS.
First log house I built was for me. Cut and grooved every log by hand. Then I built one for my neighbors. Now we're building them all over the country. Slowly, because we're still doing by hand.
Yeah, look at these blisters.
I won't compromise on my snuff either. Gotta have full tobacco flavor. I use Redwood. To me, it tastes as good as Copenhagen, just doesn't cost as much. The people who make Redwood snuff work just as hard as we do for full tobacco flavor. They give you your money's worth.
Redwood snuff tastes as good as Copenhagen, just costs less.
It's one gift inside another. Genesee 12 horse ale in this antique style wooden case with a checkerboard top. The gift of taste from Genesee.
For centuries in England, when a knight offered a lord holiday cheer, what was served?
Shrimps, Oxnard!
Or a lord quenched a duke's thirst?
Shrimps, Huggins!
Or a duke kindled a prince's holiday spirit?
Shrimps, Godfrey!
Why, even today?
More Schweppes, Dudley.
Few hosts entertain thoughts of entertainment without Schweppervescence. Schweppes, the great British bubble.
Back at RFK Stadium, where else would you see that sight? Cardinals on the move with a big 2nd-and-11 situation facing them right now. Neil Lomax, the quarterback. Back to throw, quickly. Tilly. Pat Tilly dances out of bounds. Vernon Dean, the defender, not enough for a first down. But it does put him down pretty close to O'Donohue's field goal range. Just starting the fourth quarter. Pat Summerall with John Madden at RFK Stadium. They're playing for the NFC Eastern Championship. Third down and four. The Redskins 25. Lomax to Tilly. He'll have the first down. Tilly out of bounds at about the 16. There's Neil O'Donohue. Pressure situation for everybody playing, but O'Donohue, who was just about ready to try the field goal, puts the jacket back on. But the jacket won't hide the nerves.
Remember the first time they played, Neil O'Donohue on an extra point hit the upright. Of course, they won the game later on a Neil O'Donohue field goal.
By 2 points. And now this time it's Mosley who's missed the extra point. Comes over on the right side, now goes in motion. Lomax comes out, tries to get out, is in the grasp, and is down. It came from his left side, so it has to be either Manley or Grant. It's Dexter Manley.
I think, again, Dexter Manley gets credit for the sack, and he should, but again, it was good coverage downfield because Lomax is looking downfield. He couldn't find anyone. He couldn't wait. And so he had to just take the sack on that one.
The all-time season sack leaders team-wise, that's up to date. John Madden's Oakland Raiders of 1967 had 67. Washington has 66 for this year. Farrell and Anderson. The one, here comes Roy Green in motion. Now he goes back. He'll work against Darryl Green. Outside to Farrell. Farrell skips out of one tackle. Gets down to about the 16. It'll bring up a third and long. And O'Donohue comes out of the jacket again. Guarantee you he doesn't know it's cold.
That stuff that's pumping through him right now.
The Redskins 17.
This isn't a bad situation because here on third down you don't have to go into the end zone, and a lot of defenders will defend that goal line, and you can hit stuff in front of them between the 5-yard line and the goal line. I always thought this was an excellent area to pass.
Lomax back out of the shotgun. Pat Tilly is wide to the left. Here comes the Redskin blitz. Almost picked off, almost intercepted, intended for Green, and Curtis Jordan almost had it. Lomax did have it. Lomax had no chance.
Well, he had no chance, but it was a silly pass, too, because Roy Green wasn't even up beyond the first down marker, so if he catches it, it still doesn't work. Now, the pressure's going to come from right up the middle. Charles Mann, normally, as a defensive left end. On that play, he lined up as a linebacker, faked to his left, came right up the middle. Roy Green was short of the first down anyway.
Actually, he's lucky that that was not picked off because Green wasn't open. 34 yards for O'Donohue. Heron is holding. Crowd waving their arms, trying to distract O'Donohue from 34 yards out. And he got it. O'Donohue throws a blanket over the crowd to that success. And it's 26 to 20. And we have ourselves a serious contest for the NFC Eastern Division Championship.
I like small cars.
We need more room.
Today, Chevrolet has a car for you, the midsize celebrity.
Feel the room. Ride in style. Go in comfort every mile.
Enjoy midsize room with economy and a price that's surprisingly small. Celebrity.
Lots of stuff here. If this is today's Chevrolet, I like it.
And we need it.
Drive today, Chevy. Live today, Chevy.
Live it.
Chevy.
The Great American Railroads. They were built to cut coast-to-coast travel from 5 months to 1 week and open up the West. That pioneer spirit made this country grow.
Today, I see that same spirit and energy in hundreds of small to mid-sized companies whose new ideas, new jobs, and new technologies will continue to build America. At First Jersey Securities, we specialize in discovering these emerging growth companies for today's investors with vision. First Jersey Securities, come grow with us.
Here's what caused Neil Lomax a problem on that third down. Now watch Charles Mann. He's normally a defensive end. He starts like a defensive end. He moves back a little, and then he comes in here like a linebacker, along with the linebacker, Monty Coleman. And Mann right here gets straight up the middle. Watch him. He starts in a stance, gets out of a stance. Now he comes around behind Coleman, straight up the middle. There's no blocker. Lomax has to throw it. It's short of the first down. And incomplete.
O'Donohue hit the field goal. Melton is back to receive O'Donohue's kickoff. 13-20 left to play. A lot of time. High, high kick. Melton at the 10. He is cut down hard by Victor Heflin. College basketball coming up on CBS. We'd like to remind you that the UCLA Bruins will visit Madison Square Garden to play number 4-ranked St. John's live 1 o'clock Eastern time next Saturday. Walt Hazard is the coach of the Bruins, the new UCLA head coach, and of course Lou Carnesecca, who has had so many great years with St. John's, still is their leader. First and 10 Redskins at their own 27. Didier is wide to the left. Going to work, looking for Didier. Knocked away at the last minute, but here's a penalty marker down. Wayne Smith.
Wayne Smith better stay away from that official. Better watch out, Wayne. They'll throw another one on you. Get back. Oh, I knew it.
He got another one.
Can't do that. Can't do that. They'll let you say one thing, then you have to walk away. You have to learn that. You just can't do that. He better watch it. He's going to get another,
one. Right.
44.
Here's Wayne Smith. He's 44 right here. He's breaking on the ball with Didier. He's getting his left hand in there. I can see what he's complaining about. That was awfully close. You have to let the defender go for the ball.
Got to give him a chance. Here, Mr. Riggins, and Riggins gets a couple. That'll make it second and about eight. Thomas Howard was the tackler. Riggins still on the ground.
Yeah, I think now we have in the last quarter here a 6-point difference in this game. I think turnovers or lack of turnovers are going to win or lose this game. I think the team that turns it over will probably lose.
The Cardinals have scored on all three times, all three possessions in the second half. That's Monk in motion. Here comes the blitz. And E.J. Jr. had it timed perfectly. And now they throw another penalty marker down. I don't know about that one either.
I know what they're going to say. They're going to say that E.J. Jr. had him in the grass. The referee was there. He blew his whistle, and E.J. Jr. threw him down after the whistle blew. Jr. really
personal
did.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Number 54, defense. First down.
Boy, that's a tough one. I can see what Jim Hannifin's saying. You got a blitz. You're tackling a guy, you're right in the middle, and it is difficult to stop right in the middle of a tackle. Watch E.J. Jr., he's right here. He's going to come on the blitz. He gets Theismann, and then he just doesn't stop. Watch it, he's right there behind the, right over the center, behind the nose tackle, and he's going to hit the ball right there in the gap. You see, right in the right gap. Riggins can't get to him. Now he has him here. You see the official wave his arms? Now what he's saying, because when I blew the whistle and waved my arms, you didn't stop.
Well, you can't stop in the middle of a tackle to watch the officials wave his arms.
No, that is tough. I don't know about that one.
It's a first down, whatever. We're not going to change it, and they aren't either. Theismann goes to work to Monk, and he's knocked out of bounds at about the 47.
You know, you can take a lot of things out of football, and you can have a lot of rules and so on for safety, and I'm sure that they're all right, but doggone it, you can't take aggressiveness out of there. When a middle linebacker comes free on a blitz on a quarterback, he's going to tackle him.
If you take aggressiveness out of the game, the stadium's going to be full of no-shows.
Look at Art Buck. He's a wide receiver who just set an all-time receiving record, and he looks like he's been playing in the pits. Look at those arms. Back.
Boy, what a year he's had. Theismann goes back, and he's going to look in that direction. And he's got him. And he's gotten the first down. Monk picks it up, and the clock continues to run with 11:40 left to play. E.J. Jr. on the tackle.
Now in the Redskins scheme of football, this in the last part of the, well, there's 11 minutes to go. But in the fourth quarter, that's when you get a big dose of John Riggins.
Neil Lomax over on the sideline. His offensive unit, throwing it almost every down here in the second half, has put some points on the board every time they had the ball. Now they need it again. 26 out of 34 for Lomax.
When you rub your hands through your hair, that means you want the ball back.
Monk splits wide to the left. Theismann has Riggins behind him on first down. Yellow 30 means nothing. That means he'll go to play that was called, and that goes to Riggins. Hammered by E.J. Jr. Ramsey Dardar also helped out. Yellow 30 is just a way to get things started.
Right, that's a starting thing, and it means nothing when they say, yeah, now if he says something other than yellow, then that means it's going to be an audible, which they do very few of. That was a counterplay. It was interesting to the left with Ken Huff and Mark May pulling. It's usually to the right with Grimm and Jacoby pulling. That was a little offset thing. They don't do that an awful lot.
Let's listen to Theismann now. And now they're saying that they were pulled offside.
Well, what they were doing is they had a blitz, and they're trying to time the blitz with a snap of the football.
Encroachment. Defense.
It's against the Cardinals.
I think it was E.J. Jr. again here. He's going to come on a blitz, and he gets up here and gets offside. He gets up in the other gap before the ball snap. Now watch him. He starts coming here. Now he comes over. And you see right there, he jumps off sides. He's in that neutral zone before the ball snap.
Cardinals have been penalized 10 times for 87 yards. The Redskins only once
for 5 yards.
But
they've had three big ones on this drive
alone.
In this
drive, you're right. Three tough ones.
One on Wayne Smith and two on E.J. Jr.
Riggins right side. Riggins rambles for the Redskins first down. Wayne Smith, Lee Nelson on the tackle. Riggins has 22 carries. This game, 66 yards. And believe me, John, they've been tough yards.
Well, they've been tough yards, but this is the time in the game that the Redskins need Riggins. When they get down close to the goal line, when they have a lead in the fourth quarter, just to hold the football. And there's no one better at doing that than this guy.
Redskins have the ball at the Cardinal 26. 9.5 minutes left to play. Heisman sounds like he's just about out of voice. Give this to Riggins again. Cut down right at the line of scrimmage.
Fans over on that side are calling for another penalty. They want the Cardinals to have their fourth penalty on this drive. Official said, nah, we've already got them for three. I'll tell you, when Riggins does go, you know, he gets a lot of hits, and he does take some late hits because you never know when he's down. Now watch him here, and watch this hit there. I'll tell you, that was a little late. I think the reason they didn't call it is probably that was Ramsey Dardar, and he missed him.
He just dived right over him. Cardinal defense getting a good rest. Second and 9.5. They go after Theismann. Intended for Calvin Muhammad, and Muhammad turned around when Theismann thought he was going to keep going.
Well, you know, Theismann didn't have a lot of time on that one to think about too many things because they did have the blitz on, and again, E.J. Jr. was right on Theismann, and he had to get rid of that ball.
They would be within range for Mark Mosley even if they got nothing. On this down, it would be tough. But he can get it there. Joe Washington has replaced John Riggins. It would be from 43 yards out for Mosley. They go with an unusual offensive set. One we haven't seen before. Theismann retreats, pulls it down, and is taken down and out of field goal range by Curtis Greer.
I'll tell you, that is a big, big play because, as you said, had they done nothing before that, they could have kicked the field goal. But watch Greer. He starts up on the outside of Joe Jacoby, gets his left arm in underneath, gets beyond him. Theismann was flushed out just before that, and Curtis Greer caught him from behind. Talk about big defensive plays and big sacks in your career. That was sure one for Curtis Greer.
The fifth of the day by the Cardinal defense. They have really hung tough. Jeff Hayes in the punt. He's standing right at midfield. Danny Pittman standing at the 10 for the Cardinals. 26-20. The Redskins lead it. High kick that Pittman will have to handle. And does at the 6-yard line. Hayes got it done. And one more time, the Cardinals have a long way to go. That was only a 28-yard punt. But they made Pittman handle it. 26-20 Redskins.
There'll be 50,000 people here tomorrow. The Office Automation Expo.
This company is big in computers.
They're just announcing their first system. But one company has it all right now. Professional workstations, electronic printers, file servers, and they can all work together.
They've already installed more than 800 networks worldwide. What puts this company ahead of the others? Teamwork.
It's called Grand Am.
Grand Am.
It's a true driver's coupe, and it's all new.
Grand Am.
But better than that, it's from Pontiac.
Grand Am.
And you know what that means.
We build excitement.
Coming soon, he's a private eye trying to get his son to follow in his footsteps.
Why does my father do this to me?
Jack Borden, John Rubenstein.
How's it going, son?
Crazy like a fox.
This was back in the first quarter. After after the Redskins' first touchdown, Mark Mosley's attempt at an extra point. It goes just left of the left upright. At that point, they led 6-0. But the Cardinals, who now have the ball, have a long way to go.
That's the bad news for the Cardinals. The good news for the Cardinals is that they've scored every time they've had the ball this half. Had the ball three times, and they've scored three times.
This crowd is now raucous. That's Green moving. Lomax to Danny Pittman, and Pittman's still on his feet, and that gets him some breathing room outside the 25 and the 27. A pickup of 21. Rich Mullott took him down.
Well, they had Pittman out here on the strong safety on Ken Coffey. He just runs up, runs a slant. Coffey looks like he's waiting for something. He breaks very late on the ball, and that's able to get, and that enabled the Cardinals to get a lot better field position.
Lomax is now 27 out of 35. A gain of 21 on that one. First down, Cardinals. They're all 27. Back to throw he is. With time, look out. He gets to Green. Roy Green inside Redskin territory to the 45. Darryl Green, the cover man.
I'll tell you, Roy Green came over and caught that ball. Pat Tilley was on the same side, down here on the right side. He was wide open deep, and that's why right now when Green gets right by here, that's why he has so much space out here, because Tilley is up the field, and he was...
Man hit Lomax just as he let it go.
Hey, we talk about Joe Theismann being tough. This Neil Lomax is pretty good himself.
He's also young.
He's also going to be great.
Lomax. Pittman stays in bounds, and it's another Cardinal first down. I beg your pardon, it might be a little bit short.
This was a roll on Lomax. He rolled to this side. And again, we're going to see Danny Pittman just come up. He looks, he turns to the inside on a hook, pivots to the outside. Now, I'm sure that Coffey was playing a zone there, and he was trying to get deep, and the linebacker, Mel Kaufman, was trying to get outside to help.
That stops the clock with just over 6.5 minutes left to play, and you can see what the Cardinals have done in the second half. Started at their own 8. Got a field goal out of it. Started their own 10. They got a touchdown, a 75-yarder from Lomax to Green. Started their own 29. They got another field goal. And it's 26-20 Redskins right now, second and short. Anderson to the outside and has got the first down and more. Anderson hammers a Redskin defender, Mel Kaufman, with his shoulder.
Otis Anderson got a pretty good block out there by a wide receiver. Someone was knocked down just before he got there, and he was able to pick up enough for the first down, about 5 or 6 more yards. Now, that doesn't look like much, but he's had a pretty big day, Otis Anderson.
He really has.
He caught all those passes.
And turned very short throws into substantial yardage. He's caught 10 passes for 110 yards, and he just got that clutch first down. The Cardinals were down at one time 23-7. Now it's 26-20. Lomax back to throw. Goes quickly to Pittman. My guess is, John, they finally figured out the coverage. They're putting that safety man on Pittman.
Well, right. What they're doing is now, on this drive, the Cardinals have been using 3 wide receivers. That's why they get the strong safety on Pittman, because they have Tilley and Green on one side, and then they had Danny Pittman, who they just took out, playing the receiver on the other side. And you only have 2 corners, so that means that a safety had to cover 1. So the safety covered Pittman, and that's the guy they've been throwing to.
Cardinals now have over 400 yards throwing. Here comes the Redskin blitz. Lomax has a man. Roy Green has the touchdown, and the Cardinals have a chance to take the lead. Good throw by Lomax, and Roy Green is some athlete.
Look at Jim Hannaford, he's saying, I go, we hung in there, guys. These guys here don't like it. But I'll tell you one thing, that was Darryl Green was on Roy Green. I think Darryl Green slipped. But I think Roy Green made Darryl Green slip.
He's made a lot of people slip this year. There is still a lot of time left, however. 6 minutes, 15 seconds. O'Donohue to try to break the tie. Perrin is holding. The Cardinals, for the first time today, have taken the lead. Boy, they have really hung in there.
They've had a lot of adversity, but watch this move here. He's going to come in left here to the post. You see, he's going to fake in here like he's coming in here. Now watch what that does to Darryl Green. He did slip right there, and then Roy Green broke it out to the outside in the corner for the touchdown. Darryl Green doesn't even make the picture. Now that was some move.
I think he had him even if he didn't slip.
I know it, because he, after that post move, he couldn't recover to the corner.
Cardinals ahead by one, 6:15 left to play.
So this is the new log cabin.
Thanks for giving me a hand.
Hey, what are friends for?
Here's to good friends. Tonight's kind of special.
Try it this way.
The beer we'll pour says something more somehow.
Looks like we're about done, huh?
Not yet, you're not.
Tonight.
Not a bad day's work.
Next weekend, we put in the pool.
Let it be low and brown.
The design is bold. The performance, heart-pounding. This is a new kind of LeBaron, GTS. In the slalom, GTS Premium outperforms BMW 520 AT. It's faster from 0 to 50 and stops quicker than Mercedes 190E. Performance seats, available leather-fitted cabin, advanced electronics, and the Chrysler Protection Plan. LeBaron GTS, created to outperform Europe's best. It does. I assure you.
Here is the touchdown and the move again.
I tell you, this is a great move. He has to sell him that he's going inside. Right there, he's going into the post. He sold him. Watch Darryl Green. Now he goes back. Now when he comes back, he just can't get around there to that corner.
And Jim Hannifin off with the headset.
Because he knew what the play was. He sent it in through Rod Dauhauer, who was up in the press box.
O'Donohue will kick it off. 6:15 left to play. Jones back deep for the Redskins. Again, it's not very deep and very to the 8. And they wrap him up. No, he gets out of it. Does Jones. Finally tripped up by John Good. Lomax has had some second half. 19 out of 21. 267 yards and 2 touchdowns. Both of them to Roy Green. Tell you what, we got a couple of guys in this game who wear number 81 who are just about unstoppable, Art Monk and Roy Green.
You know, and I had one years ago that wore number 81, Warren Wells, who was one of the best players that I've ever coached, and that's the reason that Roy Green is wearing number 81. Emmett Thomas, his coach, remembered Warren Wells and thought he looked like him, and he wanted him at 81.
Monk was the man in motion. They get the ball out to Art Monk. He can't hang on. He was jarred by Wayne Smith. Good play. The time remaining, just 1 second over 6 minutes. St. Louis driving for the NFC Eastern Championship. ...27-26. The score, the Cardinals over the Redskins. The winner gets the week off. The loser has to play next week. Heisman back to throw, looking quickly in the middle to Monk. He gets it to Monk. Outside the 30, about the 32. Not enough for a first down.
That's unless the Cardinals are the losers. If the Cardinals lose, then they get the whole season off. The whole rest of the season off. They're out, right?
It'll be till training camp for them. No matter if the Cardinals do win, the Redskins are still a wild card team. Third and 4. Joe Washington has replaced Theismann. This is Didier coming way right, wide left. Covered now by the linebacker, it would appear. Here come the Redskin blitzers. Theismann gets out of it. He's got the first down. Elois Grooms finally got him down.
of the thing. Watch E.J. Jr. again on the blitz. He's going to get through there. He's going to break everything up. Coming from the right side, Theismann sees him right now. Then he can't turn. Just got a piece of him. Now he feels him coming from behind. Joe said, I better get out of here. Now he gets that far and says, I better get a first down. And he did.
Joe Washington just got a piece of him, just got enough. Riggins, as we come back over the left side again, got about three. E.J. Jr. and Ramsey Dardar on the tackle. That's where they're trying to get. Either into the where the red letters are, the end zone, or in range for Mosley. Second and seven. Here is Mosley over on the sideline. Got to tie a shoe before the time comes.
Yeah, how can a kicker do that? He doesn't do anything else. All he does is kick. You know, I mean, he doesn't kick off. He doesn't punt. Just feel. How can you have to tie your shoe when you get to this part of the game? What else you been doing all day?
He just likes to tie it a lot. Calvin Muhammad by Jeff Griffin inside the 40, about the 38 or 39. Clock continues to run with 3:35 left to play.
Well, Joe Gibbs was telling us yesterday, he said, you know, if I have to pick a guy that I think has a good chance of winning this game for us, it's Calvin Muhammad. He said he's at that point now. He said they're going to be worrying about Monk. They're going to be worrying about Riggins. And he said this guy could very well be the guy that wins the game for the Redskins.
Muhammad's caught five for 110 yards. Clock running still at 3:10. Riggins back in the game. Theismann back to throw, goes quickly. Heading for Cliff Didier, who's being covered by linebacker Thomas Howard, man-to-man.
I'm sure that they saw that on the booth. You know, a couple plays ago that happened. They put Clint Didier outside, and they had Howard on him, Thomas Howard, who's usually the strong side linebacker. They put Didier out as a wide receiver, and then the Cardinals have to put their linebacker out on a man-to-man. Well, it didn't work, though.
No.
Howard covered him pretty well.
Didier's bigger than Howard. Here's Mark Mosley, got his shoe tied down. Charlie Brown is in the game as a wide receiver. Muhammad is out. Theismann is down. Elois Grooms with the sixth sack of the Redskin quarterback, and Theismann comes out of it limping.
Grooms came through on that play, and someone tried to tackle him. Watch it, it's Ken Huff here trying to block him. He does a circle. Huff tries to grab him. He gets right by him and gets in here on Theismann. What's number 61 in white? You see him, he does a circle. See, now Huff right there tries to grab him from behind. He can't stop Groom, and he gets another big sack for the Cardinals.
That's one of the few times you'll see that spin move get you anywhere. Third down and long, third and 18 for the Redskins. Theismann with time this time, going and hitting Art Monk, and he gets enough for a first down. Wayne Smith. What a clutch throw and catch. Now less than that left to play. Remember that the Redskins have already used two of their timeouts.
Watch this catch. Art Monk is the third guy. They had a guy deep, a guy short, and Monk right in the middle. But it was a third down play, and he knew enough to get up there for that first down.
He got 20 and they needed 19. The 2-minute warning has been issued. Score is 27-26, the Cardinals over the Redskins. 2 minutes to go.
Yourself a merry little Christmas now. personal computer game is heating up.
May I?
Go ahead. The AT&T personal computer is faster, 2 to 3 times faster than the IBM PC. It has a higher resolution screen, too, for better graphics, and runs thousands of business programs. In fact, it's more computer for the money to put your business ahead of the game.
Your move.
The AT&T personal computer. Call AT&T Information Systems when you've got to be right.
Monday, it's George C. Scott in a classic Christmas story as magical spirits teach lessons of the heart to a miser named Scrooge. A Christmas Carol.
Humbug.
Here was a big play to Art Monk. Here's what you call flooding a zone. Look, three receivers. One goes short, one goes deep, and Monk goes in the middle and catches maybe the biggest catch of his career. Watch him see the short, the deep, and right in the middle, that opens it up for Art Monk. Just beyond the first down marker.
That was Monk's 11th catch of the day. That equals the career single best day. What a day to set the record. Mohammed is out wide to the left. Monk is inside him. They give to Riggins. Riggins moves it closer in the middle. Lee Nelson on the stop. Like he got about five.
You mentioned earlier that the Redskins only have one timeout. I think the Cardinals should start thinking in terms of timeouts, and they have. They just took their first timeout.
So they have two left as Hanifin talks to his men and Joe Gibbs speaks with Theismann. In the last 3 years, since the Redskins have been so successful, they have never lost in the final four regular season games.
And that guy there has a lot to do with it, Joe Gibbs. They talk about the last 3 years. I think he's probably done the best coaching job of anyone in this game. I'll tell you what a job he's done, and maybe he did his best job this year. I mean, he's had so many injuries, so many things go wrong, but they just kept fighting. They just kept staying there, coming back, you know, playing different guys, bringing a guy in 1 week, playing him on Sunday. I'll tell you, he's done an outstanding job.
27-26, the timeout situation. Cardinals have two remaining, the Redskins have one. Riggins got five on that carry, make it second and five, so Riggins stays in the game. They're in range, certainly.
I'm sure Riggins will carry it again.
I'm sure you're right. Over the left side for a couple, Thomas Howard brings him down. Mosley continues to loosen up. Timeout Cardinals. Now they have one, the Redskins have one. Minute 42 left.
I think I found some candles.
I got some matches. What's that?
Here's to good friends.
Power company.
How about a little blackout party?
You're crazy.
Not entirely.
The beer we'll pour.
We need to finish the Lowenbrow. That's better.
Let it be Lowenbrow.
Last year, car makers spent a record $1 billion in advertising just to tell you how wonderful their cars are. Fortunately, there's a more objective opinion, car owners. According to a recent survey, of all cars in America, import or domestic, Subaru ranks second only to Mercedes in customer satisfaction. And that's the kind of advertising money can't buy. Subaru, inexpensive and built to stay that way.
That's how far they have to go. You look at the Cardinal defensive unit. The line of scrimmage is the Cardinal 21. Pat Summerall and John Madden, and this is for the marbles. Each team has one timeout remaining. They give to Riggins. Riggins is cut down short of the first down. And let's see if the Cardinals take their final timeout. Tonight on CBS. Here's what's coming up as Mosley comes out. 60 Minutes will be first, followed by Murder, She Wrote, The Jeffersons, Alice, and then Trapper John, M.D. Turnout will be one heck of a contest.
I know it, and even if the Redskins kick this field goal and it's good, this game isn't over, because the Cardinals, by using that those timeouts, are still going to get the ball back, and they're going to have over a minute to play. Have to remember, they've scored every time they've had the ball so far in this game.
In the second half.
The second half in this game.
Right. 37 yards out is Mosley. He's been good from that distance and from 21 already.
Well, he finally got that right shoe on now, got it all tied up. One of the few straight ahead kickers left. I think there's only two in the game.
That's right. Good snap. It's good. Mosley hits it. And now Mosley was hit by somebody and he's hurt.
Limping off.
He could be hurt, but he's very, very happy. That hurt will go away quickly.
See what happened.
That was Roy Green that was in there.
But I didn't see him hit him.
Looked like he just spun him around.
I think he slipped. But I'll tell you, 1 minute 33 seconds back. They haven't stopped him yet in the second half.
To return the kickoff.
Well, there's no reason to save anything. Give it everything you have. This is it.
Willard Harrell is back there with him, but this is Green. And there's nothing there. Down at the 20. 1:27 left to play. No timeouts left for St. Louis.
Of course, they'll do two things. One, they'll try and get the ball up the field and get out of bounds to stop the clock. Or two, if it's inside, then what they're going to do is just get up and no huddle.
And now the pressure on the kicker moves to the other side of the field. Mosley did his part. Now it goes to O'Donohue. This crowd, everybody on their feet screaming. Lomax says we can't hear. Nobody can hear.
This is going to be a problem the rest of this game. We can see the referee is now talking to Lomax and explaining to him what he has to do, because I'm sure from now on, every time the Cardinals go up to the line of scrimmage, the crowd's going to do the same thing.
O'Donohue. May look like he's exercising, but I think he's praying. There's Redskin owner Jack Kent Cook up for the press spot, pacing back and forth. Lomax gets it down the middle. Pickup of about eight, but that keeps the clock going. And remember, the Cardinals are out of timeouts.
You know, the interesting thing there, the play before, they tried to go shotgun. They couldn't get it up, so he went back to the line of scrimmage as he is now.
Willard Harrell. On second down, Lomax goes and gets Danny Pittman, and he gets out of bounds at the 41-yard line and picks up the first down. 13-yard gain and a clutch 13-yard gain. A good throw by Lomax.
Now, the Cardinals only need about 30 more yards to get within O'Donohue's field goal range. That's about two medium-sized passes.
They have a minute and 3 seconds to get it done.
This Neil Lomax has been something today. And another thing, his offensive line has done a good job of protecting him.
Redskins now going with three down linemen to rush him. He goes back in the shotgun again and goes outside to Willard Harrell, who gets it out of bounds. He got out of bounds and stopped the clock with 56 seconds left to play.
That was a good move by Willard Harrell, getting out of bounds, or a third tackle by Vernon Dean. Dean had him, and he just couldn't keep a hold of him. Watch as the Cardinals do go back in the shotgun. They're in the shotgun. He finds Harrell out here. Now watch number 32, Vernon Dean. He's up there. He has the tackle. Harrell's able to get out and get out of bounds and stop the clock. Still 56 seconds to go.
That was only a six-yard gain. 6 yards will take the Cardinals to save. But the big part of it was stopping that clock. They need approximately 23 more yards to get in O'Donoghue's range. Lomas out of the shotgun. Can't find anybody. Does find Anderson. Anderson hammers down inside the Redskin 40, but the clock will run. First down, Rich Mallott made the stop.
With a first down now, Pat, Lomax can waste the play. Just throw ones out of bounds to stop the clock.
Gotta do it quick. And he does. In the direction of Tilly. That'll make it second and 10.
That was a smart play there because he had to go without a huddle. He had first down. You can afford to waste a down. So get there, stop the clock. Now you can get your play sent in. Now you can huddle up. Now you can get everyone to know exactly what you want done. Because really, to be in field goal range, the Cardinals only need one more completion.
Neil O'Donoghue, on whom shoulders it looks like the pressure will ultimately fall, is from Ireland. He went to school at Auburn. He's been in the NFL 8 years. He came up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Lomax comes out wide right. They get it out to Anderson, and Anderson will hop out of bounds.
I said one more completion. That wasn't the one more completion. The one thing that surprises me about the Redskin defense is that they're staying with a three-man line. You know, all year, they've always been a four-man line, and here they get in this situation, and on this drive, they've stayed all the way with just three men rushing.
If the Cardinals had to try the field goal from here, it would be from 55 yards out. They'd certainly like to have O'Donoghue a little bit closer. To Pittman. They're going to have to hurry. They're going to have to hurry. Rich Mallott dragged him down. 13 seconds on the clock. They're going to have to hurry. 8 seconds.
They have too many men on the field.
6 seconds. They got him off. He got it off. It's no good.
Was trying to get in there. I tell you, we talked about Joe Gibbs, the job he's done. But Jim Hannaford has done a heck of a job with this Cardinals team also.
Look at the Redskin reaction.
That miss brought them the championship.
Merrill and friends up in Monarchy, New Jersey. Byron Williams. 29-27, the Redskins over St. Louis, and the Redskins win the championship. Executive producer is Terry O'Neill. Senior producer Charles Milton III, Sandy Grossman, the director today. Joan Petrano, the associate producer. All the rest of you, we had ourselves a heck of a contest. Gives the Redskins, John, that one big desire that they had. Of course, they wanted to win the Eastern Division Championship, but they need a week of rest, they feel, particularly for Riggins.
I think that was probably the biggest thing. Of course, you don't want to have to play more games than anyone else, but by winning the division, they get that week off, and that's what Joe Gibbs was saying yesterday, that'll help us more than anything. We just need to get healthy.
Coming up next, the NFL today, as we said. And so the Redskins win the championship 29-27 over the Cardinals. Pat Summerall and John Madden, I'll tell you, had a most enjoyable day, and we hope you did. Redskins win it by two.
Us syncopators of progressive ribs have a unique style of jawing.
Howard says jazz musicians talk funny.
And after a gig, I finger pop with a light beer from Miller.
After playing, Howard enjoys a light beer.
Light is super cool and a breeze on the calories you dig.
Light is less filling, with a third less calories than their regular beer. And the taste, Howard?
Oh, man, it's Obop Shaban. It's lay down, break down, birdie on the hot side of town.
He likes it.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer. And less.
Introducing a computer that can change the way you work. The new Tandy 1000, complete with DeskMate software for easy-to-use word processing, filing, worksheets, scheduling, communications. Brought to you by Tandy, clearly superior for service, support, and software. The Tandy 1000, available at Radio Shack Computer Centers, and so affordable. Tandy technology, service, and support are clearly superior.
And what a great game that was in RFK Stadium, 29-27. Your heart has to go out to Jim Hannaford and the St. Louis Cardinals. They did such a great job, especially in the second half, scoring every time they touched the ball except the last time. And the Redskins, again, they are the Eastern Division champions. Now, let me get you up to date in the playoff situation. I think the easiest way to do this is, as far as the NFC wild card is concerned, this is if the Dallas Cowboys win tomorrow night. Now, keep in mind, that's the big game still left. The Cowboys against the Miami Dolphins tomorrow night in Miami. If Dallas wins the game, then the Rams will go into Dallas to play the Cowboys, and our coverage starts here next Sunday at 12 noon on CBS. That's if the Cowboys beat Miami. Now, however, if Miami wins, and they are a favorite, remember, at home, and they've got the great Dan Marino, what a shootout that's going to be. If they win it, then it's going to be the New York Giants going into the wild card game, and they will travel out to Anaheim to take on the Los Angeles Rams. And check your local listings for the starting time, because we are still not sure. We're not sure where the AFC game is going to be. They are still playing for that. Right now, let me take you to the scoreboard and get you up to date, especially you folks watching that great drama in Washington. Might have missed some of the stories here this afternoon. Chicago beating Detroit 30-13, and in that game, 12 quarterback sacks by the Bears. That gives them 71 for the season. That is a new NFL record. Now, the architect of that defense, Buddy Ryan, he is a leading candidate to replace Frank Kush as the head coach of the Indianapolis Colts. First things first, the Bears are, of course, going to the NFC playoffs. Now, the Jets, they wind up 7-9. At one point in the season, the Jets were 6-2, and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers drilled them today, 41-21. It was John McKay's final game as a head coach. And wouldn't you know it, the Buccaneers would explode and score more points than they ever have under John. Indianapolis and New England, the Patriots wind up 9-7. They beat the Colts. 16-10 was the final in that game. The Green Bay Packers will have a lot of optimism going into next season. They wind up 8-8. They drilled the Minnesota Vikings 38-14. You have to wonder about Les Steckel now, simply because the transition from Bud Grant to Steckel, it was so severe. They were men of completely different personalities, and obviously the Viking players did not respond, and certainly they did not today against home against the Packers. Cincinnati and Buffalo. Now, here's a game with playoff implications, and Irv, we're going to take a look at the highlights. The Bengals exploded in that particular game, and they are just one victory away from getting into the playoffs.
Head coach Sam Weiss has to be happy with what's happened to his ball club. Here, Kenny Anderson completes a pass over the middle to Chris Collinsworth, but Collinsworth was later injured in the ballgame. This is a 27-yard gain right here. Kennebrew. It's led to a Kennebrew 14-yard touchdown run. Here, Collinsworth went down. Boomer Esiason hands the ball off to Sanford Jennings, who runs 20 yards for another touchdown. But again, Buffalo quarterback Joe Dufac has his pass for Byron Franklin picked off by James Griffin, who returns the ball 56 yards for a touchdown, and Cincinnati felt the sweet taste of victory.
Now, and let me give you the playoff situation as a result of that. The Bengals are with a chance to win the AFC Central, and it would take a victory by the Raiders over the Steelers. But wouldn't you know it, the Steelers have struck first in that game, a Gary Anderson field goal, and they lead the Raiders right now 3-0. Now, other scores, Cleveland over Houston this afternoon. It is 27-20, the final there. Here's the Steelers and the Raiders situation. It is a field goal game out in Los Angeles. It is 3-0, the Steelers with the lead over the Raiders. Kansas City and San Diego. It is two touchdowns by the Chiefs. They're up 14-0 over the Chargers. Philadelphia and Atlanta, field goal game. In case you missed the news earlier today, here on the NFL Today, the Eagles will stay in Philadelphia. We're going to continue with our post-game coverage here on CBS in just a moment.
You're off to a driving start.
Big A!
The first letter in auto parts.
We got
A! Store with the parts you need.
A
man who knows the way.
Big A!
The first letter in auto parts is all you need.
Good job.
Yeah, we've got all the parts you need, because we're the first letter in auto parts.
Big A, big A, big A.
Men never cease to amaze me. Some guys don't think twice about the cologne they use. But a cologne says a lot about a man. And I think the cologne that says it best is English Leather. English Leather has a clean, masculine scent. In fact, as far as I'm concerned, a man should wear English Leather. Or nothing at all. Look, I don't fall for a guy just because he wears a nice cologne. But I know what I like. And I like a man to wear English Leather. Or wear nothing at all.
Wow. It's nasty out there. Some day to run.
Soup looks good.
You still nervous about tomorrow?
Well, it is my first 10K run. I just hope I can do it.
Of course you can. You worked hard, ate right. Here, eat your Campbell's. It's good for you.
Campbell's Chicken Noodle Soup. It's nice when something that tastes so good can make you feel so good.
I'm surprised you're worried about finishing.
Finishing? I'm worried about winning.
Campbell's Soup is good
food. Oh, what Sylvania light bulbs go through before they come to you. As many as 38 tests in all. So that when you do this, your Sylvania light bulb will do this for an average of 1,000 hours. And isn't that the best test of all?
All right, in the NFC playoff situation now, the Washington Redskins and the San Francisco 49ers, they have the home field advantage for the divisional round. The Chicago Bears have to go on the road. The Dallas Cowboys or the New York Giants all depends on Monday night. Cowboys are in if they win. The Chicago Bears are already in, of course, with that victory today over Detroit. And let's go back out now to Tim Ryan. Tim?
All right, Brent. Well, here at the Silver Dome today, kind of an ironic twist with Greg Landry coming back as a quarterback against his old team. He was 11 for 20, 199 yards, gave up three interceptions, two of them in the Lions' end zone, but he passed for a touchdown, 55 yards to Willie Gault, ran one in himself, and led the Bears to their season-ending victory and a 10-6 record. Walter Payton, of course, is a very happy man. He's had another brilliant year, but most of all, he's pleased to be in the playoffs and winning the final game of the season. We asked him about it.
It really means a lot because, you know, going into the playoffs, you don't want to go in on a sour note. And we've had two losses, and we felt that we needed this one to get the momentum going.
Walter, you've been playing 10 years. You've waited a long time for a championship, haven't you?
I'll tell you what, this is the first championship team I've been on.
You have set any number of records this season, Walter. Is there one of that whole group that means the most to you? The obvious one would be passing Jimmy Brown, but I'd like to know your feelings about the others.
Well, you know, that does mean a lot to me. It's an indication of the way that this team has stayed together during the hard times. But I think the one that really means the most to me is back-to-back 2,000-yard seasons.
Well, what about breaking Johnny Morris's club pass receiving record?
You know, that's always a pleasure because, you know, I see Johnny every night on television with the news. And, you know, when I was a little kid, about three or four, I used to watch him on television.
Well, it's hard to know who you're going to be facing in the playoffs, Walter. It's still a little mixed up as to who your opponent will be. But it's either Washington or St. Louis or San Francisco. Have you got a preference?
Well, I tell you what, if we had to play anybody, I would rather play San Francisco to get it out the way and get the home field advantage back in Chicago.
Interesting perspective by Walter Payton. Let's go back to Brent Musburger in New York.
All right, Tim. And, of course, obviously that was recorded a short time ago. The Cardinals have been eliminated. No chance of that. And we'll continue with our postgame show on CBS in just a moment.
Remember when the most wanted gift was electric trains with switches? An Erector set with a motor. A chemistry set with a Bunsen burner. Now it's computers with disk drives and printers. Isn't it wonderful you can give a computer as powerful as the Commodore 64 for a price as low as the Commodore 64?
Thanks, Dad. Thanks, Mom. Thanks, Chip.
In today's Army, when artillery goes to the field, so does high technology.
Beat all that you can beat. Keep on reaching. Keep on growing.
Computers, laser-guided missiles, and teamwork honed to a split-second response. Only the Army gives you this kind of training with just a 2-year enlistment.
I have taken on many fighters and tried many beers. One beer isn't a class by itself. Light beer from Miller. Light tastes great, and it's less filling. It weighs in at a third less calories than the regular beer. Yes, I discovered your greatest beer, but I never met your greatest fighter. Hey, who is this Billy Martin anyway?
Billy Martin? He's warm, he's gentle, good looking too.
I got to meet this guy.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
The Washington Redskins win a divisional title, and the Los Angeles Rams go into the playoffs with a wild card as a result of that score. Let's go out to Pat Summerall and John Madden. Pat?
Well, I guess, Brent and John, we could say that perhaps we saved the best for last, didn't we?
Well, I'll tell you, we sure did. It had everything. I mean, it had the, you know, the dirt, the mud, playing here in the grass, an excited crowd, a lot of yardage, scoring right to the last second. That's what football should be.
Well, I agree with you. Give a lot of credit to the Redskins. You give a lot of credit to Neil Lomax, who had such a great day. 37 out of 46 for 468 yards. Here, however, was the key play, and John Madden's going to show you how it worked.
You know, this was third and 19. Now, watch what the Redskins did. They flooded a zone. Now, what happens here is they're going to have one guy goes deep. That's one. Then they have one guy go short, that's two. Then the big guy is right here, Art Monk. He goes in the middle of them and catches a ball for 20 yards when they needed third and 19. Now watch this. There's a short guy. The deep guy is clearing out there. Now watch Monk cut right there. You see the first down marker? Gets right beyond that, right there. gets 20 yards when they need 19, and of course that kept them alive and the drive that they kicked the field goal on.
And that set up this field goal by Mark Mosley that put them ahead, and that gave them the winning margin. Mosley went from goat to hero in just a few hours. The Cardinals came back with a chance, a tough one. Admittedly, this was from 50 yards out for O'Neal O'Donoghue. That would have won it for the Cardinals. It veered to the left. Lomax, and I know how they suffer, believe me. O'Donoghue, I see that. They got the same first name, but they don't have the same hopes at the moment. Jim Hanifin, who did such a great job for the Cardinals, as he watched O'Donoghue miss. On the other side of the field, the story was different. So, the Redskins win the NFC East, 29-27, back to Brent Musburger in New York.
All right, Pat and Jimmy and Irv, you know, there are so many folks that you want to thank this time of the year around this particular broadcast who are responsible for putting the NFL Today up on the air and our great coverage of our games that you have seen. We're going into the playoffs, but we thought that today we'd like to take a little special moment, take a look at some of the key game moments and have you meet the people who have meant so much in bringing the NFL Today to you. I know they've meant so much to me, and I want to take this opportunity to thank them all publicly and to wish all of you, of course, a very happy holiday season. We'll see you next weekend.
We're just beginning, and I know we've each been down this road a time or two. I never could make it through. I've got this feeling that we stumbled into what we've both been waiting for. And maybe even more. It doesn't matter where we've been, 'cause this time I know for sure we're going all the way. Headed for forever, and that's where we're gonna stay. The more you love me, the more I know we got it all here. We're just gonna blow it. We're going all the way. If the two of us don't want it, I'd lay my money on it. Starting today. That there's more than magic in these feelings that you found. Standing on solid ground, but now we're both ready, ready for the real thing, 'cause our dues have all been paid. We finally got it made. Believe me when I tell you there's no need to be afraid. The more I know it, we got it all here. We just don't blow it. We're going all the way. If the two of us don't want it, I'd leave on money on it. Starting today.
You've been watching CBS sports coverage of the National Football League. On behalf of all of us here at CBS Sports, I'd like to wish each and every one of you a very happy and healthy holiday season.